welcome back. No announcements this week because they're the same every week. I mean, for me at least. Kate, you got anything?
Same amount of announcements as last week. Etsy shops. Support small artists. Etsy.com/KateCraftStudioUS or Etsy.com/BadDiceCo.
Nice. Sam, do you want to say anything, or are you good?
We don't have a Codex Legendarium this Sunday, so we will be back a week from Sunday. But things are happening. Things we did say goodbye to a player last week.
We did.
Unfortunately. But things are in the works to have them be able to continue possibly participating from a distance.
Just like real life.
Yeah.
Alright, anybody else want to say anything? You got time. No, cool beans. So, last we left off, y'all did some stuff. Quoin broke open a sphere and basically, long story short, restored Bahamut back to his physical form. And because of that, Quoin got to meet their deity face to face in a form that would fit inside of the chamber you were all in. Told Quoin some nice things. Realized that one of these canaries that kind of flies around Bahamut that turn into gold dragons may have been Quoin's mentor, Yodelin the Patient. And, the party asked Bahamut if Bahamut could bring Ven back to life. Quoin asked Bahamut if Bahamut could bring Ven back to life, and Bahamut agreed, and Bahamut did some stuff. Talked to Ven that no one else really heard that conversation. And Ven was given the chance to say some parting words for the time being to the group while Ven stayed in Mount Celestia in their sort of ethereal body. And, in place of Ven coming back to life, Dax's mother came back to life.
Yeah, I showed my coworker that scene the other day, and I was crying at work.
Excellent. The party went down deeper into the catacombs after saying goodbye to Bahamut and to Ven, and discovered that Barnier was down there in an emaciated state in a cage along with some other people. And the body of Darnus, who was still alive. Flitz grabbed the body of Darnus. Barnier was taken, and there was another individual down there named David. And realized this is the man you were looking for in terms of one of your contracts. So David also left with you all. Flitz also grabbed the object sitting on the altar that resembled a point of infinite stars, or a star made of infinite points, and went back up to the streets, the city above. Got invited to the bathhouse that David's family owns as a sort of thank you for rescuing him. As you all went to the Glutton for Punishment to get snacks to pick up to bring to the spa, you met a fan of the Faust and the Furious, a self-proclaimed fan named Riqquarian Daladra, short for Ricky. Ricky is the short form.
Ricky is short for, yeah.
You imagine. And Ricky tagged along. And we left off as you all arrive. At the bathhouse. And it says, nice calligraphy on a sign. Peaceful Pastures.
I'm gonna knock on the door.
Okay.
Hello?
Someone like walks beside you. Oh, excuse me, and they just go through the door, and it's a public establishment. You can just walk in.
I think it's open, guys. I open the door.
Okay. Upon entering the building, you're immediately greeted by the scent of morning dew, lavender, an assortment of spicy and sweet fragrances. Whatever you can think of, that's what you can smell, essentially. As long as they fit a bathhouse. No dung smells, no funny smells. The entry lobby of the establishment is simple in its design, with a desk pressed against the wall adjacent to the front door, and is covered in a series of small potted plants. The leftmost wall of this lobby is made of glass, and behind this glass is a large indoor butterfly garden filled with various sizes and colors of butterflies, including small walking paths, and every so often you can see a colorful mist spritz into that area. The rightmost wall of this lobby contains a simple wooden door, with a sign that reads Paradise Ahead. And you recognize David, the man you rescued from the catacombs earlier, as he approaches from behind this door and approaches the desk, motioning for you all to move forward. And he seems in a much better state than when you left him earlier.
We brought pastries and drinks.
Oh, excellent. His short brown hair appears to have been washed. He's now wearing a light gray shirt and pants with the logo of the spa on the left breast. The logo appears to be that of a collection of butterflies, all spelling out the name of the spa, Peaceful Pastures. That's a lot of pastries.
Well, we assumed we were feeding a lot of people. It's for everyone. It's for your family, and also we got ourselves something to eat. Oh, also, this is Ricky. He wasn't here before, but we picked him up at the cafe. I hope you don't mind.
Not at all. A friend of yours is a friend of mine. That's a lot of pastries.
You could do the pastries like a spread. You know, like every good place has something to munch on and nibble on. We're not going to eat all of it.
Okay, there's a table. I can just... He sets up a quick table that he had somewhere and just sets it up and says, you can just put them here.
Plastic folding tape.
two chairs.
I don't really have a place to set this up, because just... Here, I'll guide you through the place first, and then you can decide what to do with your pastries and drinks.
We might find a place on the tour.
He hands you each one of the softest towels you have ever felt in your life.
Well, that's not made of hemp or burlap.
Burlap towel.
Softer than a newborn kitten.
The towels are aquamarine in color and have the logo of the spa in one of the corners, and they're exceptionally warm, like comfortably warm, and smell of mint.
What are these made out of?
That's a family secret.
what animal are they?
Oh, no animal.
Good. These are plant-based?
No, it's
they're probably cotton.
Take these and these. He also hands you each a pair of really comfortable-looking turquoise sandals.
Just like
that you'd see in a spa. Those kind of flip-floppy style. An extremely soft cotton turquoise bathrobe. And points towards the door he just came out of. Go through there. You'll find the change rooms on your right. Outside clothing, weapons, and whatnot must be left in there. Hence, I have given you new things to dress in. Slip into these robes, and you'll be ready for some relaxation and the tour. And he hands you each a frosted highball glass with a bright orange liquid that is slightly fizzing inside. Each glass is set with a small umbrella, and oddly, each umbrella has a small cartoon version of each of your faces on it.
Oh.
Truck would like to dimension where, like, kind of looking at, kind of needing to disrobe and change.
Right not now. Right here. You're in the lobby right now. He's gestured to where you can do that. There's a change room beyond the door he just came through.
Oh, I thought he was asking us to dump all of our stuff.
Oh, not right now. He gestured towards the change room and said, go through there and you'll find the change rooms on your right. Outside clothing and weapons are not permitted in the spa itself.
I'm just imagining.
So Druk is totally like, yeah.
Oh, no. No public indecency here. We have children that come through here and other people. They don't want to see
you. I assure you I am quite decent.
I ask that you go and do it in the change room, please. No one wants to see that.
I think someone would. Like, maybe the right person might want
people that come here don't have that sort of expectation, it would make people very uncomfortable to see.
Neither do I.
Bits and danglies.
You're the one taking this to a weird
place. I'm just
saying
there's a change room.
All right. Thank you.
And he gives you each the glass, the frosted highball glass. Some mimosas to start your day?
Yeah.
The juice, if you will.
Oh, of course. And he, you can see he taps on the glass a couple times. 3 times. And nothing really happens. He says, if you're like me and don't drink alcohol, simply tap the little umbrella 3 times and the alcohol will be magically siphoned away.
Cool.
So he taps Quoin's umbrella 3 times.
Could you tap it like 6 times and it'd be more alcohol?
No.
Less?
No.
All right. Flitz is just going to start making his way to the changing room.
Druk kind of does like a jokey thing with Kenna and taps hers twice real quick.
I tapped Druk's twice.
Oh!
Or I tried.
We're still
well, that's not fair. I'm not as tall as you.
We're still open for business. But I'll meet you all here in the lobby at sundown for the VIP experience. My father insisted. For now, I'll distract myself with work and a pastry. And he grabs a pastry that he requested, which resembles a small pumpkin made from what can only be described as marshmallow and gingerbread. So go through there. Again, tonight will be your VIP experience that was promised. Everything is still on the house for the day, so enjoy your stay. If you have any questions while in there, and he points towards the door, just call Mercutio. Also, feel free to explore the butterfly garden as well. And he says, I'll figure out what to do with your pastries. Unless you want to bring them with you?
We'll probably end up bringing some with us,
okay,
if that's all right.
I'll leave some here for guests and my family.
Treat
yeah,
of,
sure.
Sponsored by Treat of, you know, Faust and the Furious.
Okay, he draws like a little sign and puts it up in the pastry. In the pastry.
Breakfast bar sponsored by.
Yeah,
yeah.
Breakfast
yeah.
bar sponsored by the Faust and the Furious, and he puts a little sign in the pastries.
Well, maybe we should save them. Nah, it's okay.
But, go change and, wander about. Have fun. Everything is on the house today, so.
Yeah, Flitz is gonna like charge into
the changing area.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So is Quoin. This is the first time we haven't had the Ven laundry service.
Yeah.
So
he'll have the Flitz laundry service.
Flitz is exclusive.
I'll do it. I'll do it in honor of Ven.
Well, I was gonna say, Quoin wouldn't have felt comfortable. So as he's taking it off. Ooh, I'm just really letting the stank out.
Well,
just going,
we're not there
no.
yet.
Oh, no?
We're not in the change room yet, no. Okay. So, pushing beyond the door that reads Paradise Ahead,
mm-hmm.
you see a long, wide hallway of granite floor and turquoise walls that stretches ahead about 50 feet and is lined with wooden doors. The corridor is brightly lit by chandeliers hanging from the ceiling and potted plants sit in every corner. To the right, you see an archway and a sign that reads "Change Rooms." You see a massive ogre wandering about, wearing his robe and towel, and a towel wrapped around his head. He has a green face mask on, and is humming to himself as he brushes past and enters through one of the doors. And yeah, you can see the place is pretty busy.
Does he have a donkey companion?
He has a bipedal donkey companion.
Oh.
Shablam. There it is. That's all I wanted.
He's like, don't get in here.
Let's just gonna excitedly run into the changing room.
Okay.
you mentioned that there's a spot where all of our gear would go.
It's you'll have to go to the change room. It's in the change room.
Alright. Yeah. So, We're all in there, right? You just like
in the chain.
Flitz,
yeah,
Flitz ran there.
Yeah,
okay.
Quoin as well.
Okay. The change rooms are made up of numerous small private rooms, as witnessed by the numerous wooden doors where small plaques have been set with the current guest's name. The doors appear to be pretty secure with their locks. You can catch a glimpse of a door marked Faust and the Furious.
Ooh, we get our own room. Alright.
But you don't have a key.
Mercutio?
An individual appears when you call upon Mercutio. You see a hulking minotaur who stands about 9'1", incredibly muscular and lean. He's mostly covered in gray skin with a long braided beard of black hair with some grays scattered within. He has a mohawk of black hair that is also braided in places, blue eyes, and is wearing a simple gray cloth vest and a gray toga-like skirt, and his horns resemble that of a Texas longhorn. Yeah, how can I help you?
It seems the door's locked.
Oh, are you the Faust and the Furious?
Yeah.
Alright, all you need to do is just put your hand on the door and it'll open for you.
Oh, really? Is that simple?
Yep.
Alright, I put my hand on the doorknob.
And you can hear the lock, you can hear, like, mechanisms start to, like, click and whiz and grind, and then the door opens.
Thank you. Apologies for calling you for a stupid question.
Not at all. Here to serve. We'll help. Here to help.
I have a question.
Yeah, of course.
What if we want to use our fist to open the door? Like, yeah, if we just give it, dap it up, and
yeah,
it opens
for us?
Yeah,
that'll work. Yeah, as long as one of your group is physically touching the door, it'll open.
Can we also give access to our friend Ricky?
Yeah, of course.
Oh, yeah, I was going to ask, what room should I change in?
Oh, no,
I'm not actually in the...
Well, you're with
them.
you're with them, though, so this is your change room as well.
Am I?
You're their guest, so...
I am? Oh, yes, you're giving us some vital information. We're having a discussion we established. You are currently within our presence, therefore you are with us.
Okay.
But yeah, just lay a part of yourself on the door and it'll open. Anything else?
Mercutio, one question. Is this like a public place? Correct?
Yeah.
Like, it's not free to use, though, right?
No.
How much would it cost for, like, someone, you know, an everyday person?
Depends how long they want to spend here.
Oh, it's like an hourly rate.
Yeah.
So if I gave you, like, 100 gold pieces, would that be able to cover some people's stays?
That could cover 2 people for a whole day.
Sure, and then you could just break it up however. Just pull from this for whoever wants to come through.
I'll deliver this to the owner.
Sure, yeah. He'll take his pot and his bottle and get a pouch and pat. He'll do 50 gold pieces and 5 platinum pieces.
All right. Anything else before I get to it?
Nope, that's it. Thank you.
Would you lack a pastry?
Not a fan of sugar, unfortunately.
Fair enough.
Gotta keep these muscles tight.
Well, there are some protein bran muffins out there that we got as well.
And he wants. So, he's I'll have to grab one of those.
Banana nut.
Yeah. You had me at protein.
I figured. Enjoy the rest of your day, Mercutio.
Enjoy the rest of yours. Explore the entire place.
Tips?
Oh, any tips? Butterfly Garden's real fun. They say.
Do you take tips?
Do I take tips?
Here's 5 gold.
I do now.
There you go. Enjoy. Thank you.
He disappears.
Well, he was real mad.
Running into his room.
Okay, so as you touch the door that sparked Faust and the Furious Flitz. Ken already touched it, so it opened. Inside your private change room, you see about 8 booths set with wooden doors and dark purple vanity curtains. Each booth contains numerous hooks to hang clothing and other supplies while you experience what this place has to offer. Each booth also seems to contain 2 small complimentary chocolates and a small clay pot containing a green mixture similar to the face mask that the ogre was wearing. A small card is set behind the pot which reads, "Seaweed and Cucumber Face Mask. Apply and keep on for 2 hours. Experience the bliss of a perfectly clean and smooth face." On the back of each, on the back of the door to your private room is a sign that reads, keep all belongings inside. Any non-spot items brought beyond this point will be confiscated. Do your duty to stop the spread of germs.
All right.
And that's, yeah. That's the change room and then the private booths for everyone to change in. Your own little separate booth.
Do y'all get this a lot? Is this like a normal occurrence for y'all?
It has to be. They're famous.
I have never sparred before.
Yeah, this is like our first complimentary service.
Who hasn't had a spa day before? Okay.
Brother, Flitz will walk you through it
all. We had spa days at the academy regularly. It was de-stressor, and just at the end of the week, we had some of our alchemists mix up nice concoctions.
Ben would have loved this.
Ben absolutely was the one that had to like mix up the face masks and like clean the towels.
Ben would have loved this. Ben actually would have hated this.
He would have had like
this flashback. Would have
loved being on this side of the spa day.
making the concoction.
Yeah, you would have like smiled and tipped every other worker and been like, "Hey, I don't know how you did that with the mask. I've had to do those before. Amazing." And you made the towels a swan.
So
I don't even.
So one of the reasons why Druk even stuck with the group is that, compared to how he had been living his life, every day with Ven was a spa day.
Yeah,
very true. Yeah,
was the spa.
I was always clean, cleansed.
So this is your change room. You got little chocolates. The chocolates are shaped. If anyone like, yeah, you get two little tiny chocolates you'd get in like a hotel. Like little tiny complimentary chocolates.
Little pillow mix. Both.
Yeah, Flitz. What does yours taste like? What's like Flitz's favorite food? These chocolates taste like, is your favorite food.
So I think it starts off as chocolate because that's like that initial thought is like, ooh,
weird,
chocolate.
It's weird when you eat something and it doesn't taste like what you think it's going to taste like. So it's really off-putting. Right. So it starts as chocolate and then its flavor drifts into
like Flitz's favorite, into
Flitz's favorite food.
Yeah, I would think Flitz wants to keep on this like luxury, like almost like relaxation. So like a nice warm, probably like apple pie, you know.
I know.
And then like something like cranberry pie, something his like mom or like relatives made back in Hollyshire. Something that reminds him a little bit of home.
Yeah, there's a lot. They make a lot of hot fruit pies in Hollyshire and a lot of meat pies.
Yeah.
It's a very
on that.
Okay. Yeah, Hollyshire is a very pie heavy place.
It's a pie
Flitz
economy.
Flitz missed out a little bit on the mass consumption of pie. He's a little whenever he got out, he doesn't have the pie weight, if you will. the years and years of just consuming endless amounts of pies. Right. But yeah, I think he kind of
A beer gut is the equivalent to a pie belly.
Yeah, at Holly Shack.
Who tries their chocolates next? Okay, Ricky, you eat your chocolate first. You've never had chocolate before.
Yeah. So honestly, it's probably because you said it still tastes like chocolate at first,
And then it drifts into your favorite food, the best thing you've ever eaten.
Well, so that's the thing.
So
for
it's gonna
Ricky,
stay chocolate.
Yeah, for Ricky, it probably just he tastes it and he's like, "Oh my god, this is incredible!" And then it just stays chocolate because that just is the best thing he's ever tasted.
All right, who's next?
I'll go next.
Okay, you eat your chocolate. Again, it starts off as like chocolate, like just a basic hotel dark chocolate, but then it drifts into Kenna's favorite food.
It turns into a, what is it? A pound cake with strawberries in strawberry syrup and whipped cream.
Awesome.
And that's the dessert that their mom would make them for their birthday.
Awesome. Who's next?
Quoin.
Okay, so starts off as chocolate.
And then it starts to get a little bit gritty and starts to explode with mint.
Oh, okay.
Like a cool, like mint, but like like the gritty pumice-iness of like when you go to the dentist and it's like a fresh clean.
Yeah.
Because Quoin grew up on the street, so it's the most pleasurable feeling in Quoin's mouth, like the mouth feel is like just fresh cleanliness, and like that is beyond any food flavor.
Okay.
So it's just kind of like, oh, tear. No, you get back in there.
All right. Druk or Dax, any of you eating these chocolates?
Oh, Dax would 100% pick it up. and they like pop it in their mouth. And to them, it totally not going the sweet route to them. It starts to taste like their mom's stew that they used to make when it was like on a nice, like cold day after like a long hunt with their dad.
Okay. Does Druk eat any of these chocolates?
Sure, yeah.
Alright, so it starts off as, you know, hotel dark chocolate, and then it drifts into whatever would be Druk's favorite food or the best thing Druk ever ate.
You see him look like he's gonna throw up.
Oh no.
And,
oh no.
And then, and then he just kind of like looks around at everybody else, and then
I think it's your moment.
Takes a swig of like his water skin.
It's your moment in the stall, I think, because we're all in our
They're all private.
Yeah. So we're in our stalls. Yes.
I had a feeling it was gonna be that one. It hurt my heart already.
We missed that. I think we missed that.
Oh no, I got it.
But you all can.
Flitz is whistling. He's humming a little bit, very loudly. Like he's not. He's ready to get this started.
Do you all change?
While Flitz is in his changing room, though, he's gonna. So all of his gear is going into his bottle.
Okay.
So essentially, all he's gonna really leave behind are probably his like mundane clothes, but a lot of his magic items and such like that.
Okay.
Are gonna be staying in the bottle, but he's gonna take a little piece of parchment and quill and ink, and he's gonna write a little note, very brief, and he's gonna fold it up, and he's gonna put his little ring that has the ferrets on it, and he's gonna put it in the middle of the note, and he's gonna fold it up, and it's gonna be like a nice little origami like a little origami bird, and the ring is going to be like sitting in the back.
Okay.
And he's going to kind of set it there for a second as he's like getting his stuff changed.
Sure.
Quoin is taking off the armor, like slowly, also having to peel off his clothes, which is a sensation he hasn't had since meeting Ven. He's like used to be really into the stank because it like kind of meant you worked hard and but now it's kind of like it's getting like that taking it all the clothes off, like putting the clothes on the side. Is there like a laundry service at this
point? You're not sure. All you can see in this changing room are just little hooks in your stall.
Okay, so then clothes are going on the hooks.
Okay, as soon as you put your dirty clothes on the hooks, they instantly clean.
Oh,
you just need to hang yourself on the hooks and you're good.
puts the armor and everything into his the goad's chest, and then he takes the sword and says transfer into the chest. It goes over and onto Druk first. Yeah. I was wondering if you. Oh wow, I lost coin right now. I was hoping to give you the opportunity to. He points at the chest. You just say transfer.
Oh yes. Oh, yes, I had done that with a couple of other things, but for this, absolutely.
And he'll take out the Crimson Arc crossbow and say transfer.
All right.
Then I want to go around and
give
everyone the opportunity to do that. We don't have to roll
play. We don't need to do
it. But if anybody wants to transfer anything today, that hasn't.
You get one item per person today.
So Riqquarian is getting undressed and like stuff and taking all this stuff off. It's like his boots look pretty nice. And he's got a ring that he probably takes off because does jewelry come off too? Is it everything?
It has to be everything, yeah.
Okay, so like taking a ring off and putting it in his bag and stuff, but like other than that,
unless it's piercings that are like stuck in your body, yeah.
But yeah, and then it's like a private changing booth, right?
Yeah, they're private changing rooms with curtains.
Then okay, they wouldn't see the other part. So yeah, Ricky just comes out. He's just like with his backpack, with like his boots, just like the laces, just like tied or to like one of the straps of the backpack. Just like no weapons in sight, no armor in sight.
Would I be able to take my crystal in with me? Is there like a pocket
nothing
I can stick it in
at
the
all?
Robe?
No pockets.
Ooh.
Swallow okay. it. Just swallow
I mean,
it
so yeah. So yeah, Kenna, so if you wanted to transfer,
yeah,
anything...
I'm gonna. But the thing is, would I still be attuned to it if I did that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, then yeah, I'll transfer my crystal.
You won't lose attunement if you focus on attuning to it, attune to something else if it was the earliest thing you attuned to, or if you die.
Okay.
That's a spawn.
And then Dax would get
so...
the same.
I haven't transferred anything, and that's the thing where, like, you could say it and you can, like, retrieve it from anywhere,
yeah.
right?
Yeah, any pocket or, like, storage container.
Yeah, any pocket, storage container.
Butt pocket. No.
I was thinking of that joke.
What, prison wallet?
Prison wallet. Right out of the prison wallet.
They'll transfer the Titan's Tooth Claymore.
Okay.
I'll pull that out of the prison pocket.
Okay. Did I put a weight limit on the chest? I can't remember. I don't think I did. I don't think there's a limit on it.
I don't remember. It's pretty high if there is.
Yeah, I know there's a limit of like the radius, but nothing you guys have in your possession is big enough. It's all good. I don't think there is. I think I got rid of that because that's not fun.
Dax feels so awkward in these flip-flops. They're so used to having like good shoes on for like hiking, going in like the woods and stuff, and they're just like, you know how like you can make that flip-flop sound, like you can like have it on your toes and kind of like kick it back a bit? They're just like doing that because it just feels so weird to have like flimsy material on their feet.
The chest is an endless void, so there's no similar to a bag of holding, but has no limit on what it can hold. So it can you can hold like it's unlimited in terms of its capacity.
So then, Quoin is going to turn it back into a pendant or a little coin on his chest, and then get down. And it's going to do the really cool guy move: just towel around the waist. You know what? What if I go towel all the way up top?
There you
go. Towel all the way up top.
You got a towel. You got your bathrobe. These turquoise bathrobes, turquoise flip flops.
Then I'll go towel on hips. Then if I'm not doing all the way up top. It's just fun stuff. Just goofing. Just cool
goofing.
Everybody dressed?
And yeah, is just wearing a necklace okay, or is that
probably not, because I said Ven couldn't have a ring. Or Ricky couldn't have a ring.
Oh, no ring. I didn't hear that. I apologize. Then you know what? Then it's hung up.
Also, remember, you can conceal it to look like a coin.
Oh, yeah, yeah. No, I mean, that's what
I'm
saying.
It is a coin, yeah.
Oh, right, you made it into a necklace. That's right, I forgot.
It's a coin necklace, yeah.
For some reason, yeah, never mind. Yeah, that's right.
I mean, I could also just put it in my mouth.
And swallow it.
the precedent of your time.
Keep it safe.
While everybody's kind of gathering up, Flitz is gonna... While he's... before, as he like comes out, he's going to while he's in the changing room, he's gonna cast Mage Hand really quietly, as quietly as he can.
Sure.
And he's gonna have his robe kind of wrapped around him, but he's gonna have the Mage Hand kind of almost hover like it's going to be holding the origami bird with the ring in it, and he's going to keep it kind of like hidden as he walks out. And as he like, when the group goes to leave, he's going to kind of open so the robe and the mage hand can fly, and just set it on the ground, because these are like, you said they're like curtains.
Yeah.
He's gonna, it's gonna go through and set it on the ground at Quoin's.
Okay.
This little origami bird with the ring in it.
But we're all leaving, so I don't.
He's see not. Yeah, it's gonna be something that he's gonna
come
do
back later.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Got it.
Right. All right, let's go. He's gonna like try to usher everybody out.
Mm-hmm. Are you excited, Mother?
Oh right, I'm here.
I asked her something earlier, and she just brushed me off, and I was just like, "It's fine."
I forgot.
I did too.
Are there any
Dax
weapons?
Doesn't.
Are there any weapons you would like to put inside of the chest? No, okay.
Frying pan.
Ooh, little Samwise Gamgee action.
She makes a fantastic stew, Quoin, I gotta say.
Frying pan?
You should get that enchanted so it does real damage.
Kenna comes out of their stall just like, "Woo! Who's ready to relax?"
I love that Kenna probably still has that beard.
Yeah, I still got the beard.
And your hair would still be...
I'm like, it's like starting to grow out a little bit. It's been like a day or two.
Yeah, your eyebrows are starting to grow back too.
Yeah.
Oh, like yeah.
Just like the outline of my hairline on the top of my head.
Yeah, the eyebrows are just coming back.
Gosh, I forgot
it's only
about
been
that.
It's only been a few days, yeah.
Beard is still going strong though.
Because that's the belt, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The belt brought the belt instantly brought the beard back.
Yeah.
Nothing else. Do you all proceed deeper into paradise?
Blitz isn't going in that butterfly room, by the way.
You're not
going
to go in the butterfly room?
Nope. He was 2,000,000% traumatized by the last session. So he is. Nope, and it wasn't even like he had a full week to process what happened. It was from
2 minutes ago.
Yeah, it was less than a walk away. So he'll let the others go and enjoy it, but right. He is gonna probably wait on the other side.
Sure. Everyone's leaving the change room and going back into the.
Yeah, he's
quarter.
Rubbing the
face mask on.
Oh,
his face.
Yeah.
You take this and you put it on your face.
Oh yes, it's really good for your skin. It does all kinds of. You could actually put it like on your neck. Some people put it on their shoulders. Oh, you're just going right in. You
just
want to avoid
smashing.
Your eyes though. They could potentially burn.
It's cucumber and seaweed. It's perfectly fine.
Okay.
Just like just with all the grace of a steam shovel trying to dig up a teapot.
Ricky's eating it.
Like. Yeah, just like
ride them like, home. That reminds him
of
home.
And just starts smashing it all over, like going past the face a little, but like, oh, whoop, you said neck, okay.
Then
just like full head, like
just
swamp thing
head.
Monster, swamp thing monster mask. Because I don't think Quoin has hair.
You don't.
Like he just dunked his head.
Yeah, it's kind of just swamp thing monster mask.
Okay.
Like just, hey, if it's good enough for the front, it's good enough.
And
for
you
back,
notice
baby.
That Quoin. Real quick, we'll get right back to you. We'll get to you, Dracus. Real quick, Quoin, when you did all that, it seems like they should have used this clay pot and like 3 other clay pots, but the clay pot's still full.
On the other end of the spectrum, Druk is nothing but hair.
Yes.
Maybe
your lips.
Nice conditioning treatment for the fur.
You would not put a face mask on your fur though.
Yeah,
put it on the beard.
He goes and just does like the part where there's very less hair, which is like kind of right under
your
the
ears.
Eyes
your ears, Jorok, don't forget those.
The inside of his ears.
Yeah,
they're still pretty furry, but yeah, you'll get the.
No, that's true.
Remember, use your ring finger when applying it because you don't want to burst any capillaries. You want to be gentle.
Who's all putting
as
who's all putting
Quoin just
don't forget to be gentle.
Who's all putting face masks on?
Ricky is like he samples it and then he's in the middle of eating it when he looks over and sees what you're supposed to do with it before he like he's in mid scoop for another bite when he sees that and then just goes
it tastes like cucumber and seaweed. It just tastes like
There's something off about this guacamole.
Great.
A lot of savory flavor.
It doesn't taste like... Oh.
I brought the tortilla chips for nothing. God damn it.
Tortilla chips and cucumber?
Oh, you gotta get white bread for cucumbers.
Yep. So who's all putting on a face mask?
Going, because I mean, Flitz,
it counts for Druk.
Druk's just going through the motions, honestly. He's like, this is how we're going to relax. All right, I see that. I'll do what I can with this.
All right. So
are there any hair clips or anything in here?
No.
Wow.
So, all of you who put on a face mask, it's very cool and refreshing to the face almost instantly. I need one of you to roll me a d20. Could be any one of you.
Let's make Ricky do it, the new guy.
Yeah, Ricky.
Yeah, Ricky.
What'd you get?
Amazing.
Nice. Yeah, that's how it
good
is.
Roll, Ricky.
I'm watching on the stream overlay, so I didn't see that. What'd you get?
Oh, one.
One. Oh, okay. So for the next 24 hours, since you all wore a face mask, each of you can add a plus one to any ability score, attack roll, or saving throw you make.
Yes!
Better than nothing.
Ricky!
Wow. Ricky's influence already.
But you're all face masked up. That's any everyone who put on a face mask.
Cool.
Nice. So you can add a plus one to any roll or just one plus
any roll? It doesn't run out. For 24 hours, you can add a plus one to everything. Cool. So,
that's great. That's
20.
That's great.
Yeah, it could have been a plus 20 for 24 hours.
Wow.
It's all right.
Rip, man, Ricky, you really dropped the ball on that one.
Everybody was just like, hey, Ricky.
No, Ricky's great. Ricky's like, great.
Oh, my God.
Dude,
wait.
Now we know how good it could have been.
But also, that means we need to come back to the spa like anytime we go fight a dragon or something.
Yeah.
Plus 20 on all rolls, that'd be
We're
ridiculous.
We're gonna only make Ricky make the rolls though, so we'll see how
that yeah,
that's the balance.
Plus 30 on a
but,
spell.
But it lasts for 24 hours, and you have until 11 a.m. tomorrow. So why not you get plus one on every roll until 11 a.m. tomorrow?
Wow.
Yep.
Let's use as many RP rolls as we can.
I want to make an insight check on the door.
It's a door. But yeah, so yeah, that's the change rooms. You all venture out of the change rooms and get to the spa itself.
Dax is taking her two long braids and they're wrapping them like around almost like a headband, and they're taking the back where the two elastics would be and they're putting them over each other in case, because she's thinking spa, I'm like, oh, if there's water, she doesn't want to get her hair too wet.
Fair enough.
Quoin takes the bathrobe off, just kind of drapes it so that his wings can stretch and get a little like air in them, because they've been the last, I don't know, 20 to 25 days.
Yeah.
No, not even. The last long little bit.
Yeah, they've been kind of
gameplay
wise. They've been cooped up, yeah.
But they've been tucked in. Just, like,
yeah.
There's been a penance being paid.
All right, so out of the change rooms and into paradise.
Yeah.
Okay, so you get back into that corridor where you saw the granite floor and turquoise walls, and there's just all these doors along the walls.
So do you think it is more than one dice? Do you think the two of them are identical? Or what do you think makes them a pair?
I mean, they might lead to two different places.
Okay. The pairs of dice might lead to two different places.
I'm so confused.
Yeah, you said it goes to a pair of dice.
Yeah. Yep.
Oh my god.
Yep. Yep. Oh my god. Yep.
Let's immediately get to the aneurysm. Just...
Oh,
sorry,
no.
Brain shut off. I'm in relax.
I did not even register why you said that. I was like, what the fuck?
Yeah, what's going on?
Bruno worky.
But the corridor, each door is set with a wooden sign.
What do the wooden signs say? In common?
Yeah, it's all in common. Private room 1 is the first door on the left.
Is there a pirate in there?
private.
Private, private.
You think a pirate lived in there? The door marked private?
Well, maybe a private pirate. Or privateer.
The first door on the right leads to private room 2.
Another privateer?
So, did we talk to... What was the magic... Mercutio.
He appears in the corridor. Yeah, what's up?
What is the next step?
Find your private room.
How do we know it's ours?
It'll have Faust and the Furious on it.
Obviously, everyone.
Do you mind if we get a different private room, a separate one?
We'll check out your room first and go from there.
Okay.
You might not be expecting what you're expecting.
Okay, this is... So we'll just keep walking then?
Yeah.
Beautiful. Thank you.
Like I said, there's rooms enough for privacy. You don't have to all share something if you don't want to. Like I said, all will be laid bare when you find your place.
All?
It's a saying. You're not.
Okay. I mean, where I'm from. I guess you know. I'm still never really into. Anyway.
If you want to hang dong, feel free.
I'm really used to seeing it. Let me tell you.
So am I.
Yeah, working here, I bet.
Yeah, I see a lot of little sausages all the time. Big ones, small ones, some as big as your head. So,
just a lovely bunch of coconuts.
Anything else?
No, I think we'll just try to find our room.
Yes, thank you.
And he disappears. The second door on the left reads K. Monsoza. The second door on the right...
Kevin Monsoza?
K. Monsoza. The second door on the right leads to a room that says Faust and the Furious.
I think this is it, guys.
Let's have a look.
Okay. In the center of this private chamber is a large communal pool that is emanating a thick steam and obscuring most of the chamber. It's very reminiscent of a Roman bathhouse in its aesthetic, with some more modern additions. The pool seems to have a shallow end that looks to be 2 feet deep, while the deeper portion of the pool seems to only be about 4 feet deep. Floating on the surface of the water are a variety of colorful flower petals which seem to give the water a rosy hue. On both ends of the pool are silver faucets that seem to dispense different scented soaps to make this bubble bath, should you so choose. Set into the ceiling is a massive painted mural depicting a bunch of goats in a field being herded by a lone shepherd. Beautiful red silks hang from the ceiling and drape around, creating a sort of canopy within the chamber. These silks seem unaffected by the steam and moisture in the air. Sitting against the walls are a series of stone benches. In between every two benches are a series of stone basins filled with hot stones and smaller basins filled with water. The room is also dimly lit by oil lamps hanging off of the walls. You'd expect the moisture to cause the flames to be snuffed out, but they're still going. And there's doors all over the place. There's two doors on the left wall, two doors on the right wall. And then this massive communal bath.
Get him out! No, I'm just kidding. I think I would be the first one to just slide in to the communal bath.
Okay, it's warm. You can see the faucet just has a bunch, it's got a bunch of labels on it.
Mm-hmm.
Well, not labels, engravings into the faucet.
So yeah, Quoin, we go to a faucet and like look at the engravings.
Okay, one is lavender, mm-hmm. One's pine, spearmint, ocean rain, black licorice, cherry blossom, sandalwood, ginger citrus, apple pie, and vanilla chai.
I mean, you had me at spearmint.
Okay.
It's a weapon and a delicious seasoning.
And the entire room starts to smell of spearmint, and the bath is filled with spearminty green colored bubbles, so it becomes a bubble bath almost instantaneously.
Oh, my sinuses are so clear.
Whoa.
Oh, man, I haven't breathed this good since... I don't think ever. Quoin, are you all right?
Never better.
I've just never heard you make that sound before.
I've never accidentally snorted about 2 pounds of bubbles.
Yeah, it doesn't taste as good as it smells.
Oh, it's even better. Quoin just fully gets right. It just
okay.
Dreckle, go over to Kenna, tap him on the shoulder, and get kind of close.
I think Ven was holding out on us about something. Perhaps a little pre-gaming is in order.
And he
sorry,
like,
you were really hard to hear. Can you repeat that? I only got about half of it, Garrett. I'm sorry.
No, that's all right. Drek essentially like looks at you, gives you like kind of look, and then like gestures to one of the segmented rooms, or like one of the offshoots.
Whoa.
Yeah, there's 2 doors on the left wall, 2 doors on the right wall.
I just wink at Drek.
Yeah.
Salted pork.
And I follow Drek out.
Yeah.
Into one of the segmented rooms? Which one? Left or right wall?
Yeah.
Left.
All right, the left room. Left room, you see a long massage table.
Right. So, Kenna, looks like Ven's holding out.
And as you're in here, a little gnome appears on the bench. Hey, how's it going? You looking for a massage?
I think we're good for now. We were just looking for some privacy.
All right, I can do privacy.
Could you get out, please?
Holds her hand
we'll call
out.
For you when you
her,
need
holds
you.
Holds her hand out.
Really, man?
Alright. Let's find a different
and then disappears.
We'll go to the right. Bro.
No, they disappear.
Oh, okay.
Oh, well, he's gone now. We should just stay here.
Alright. Well, when I was digging through Ven's things, I found this. I don't know what it is, but it looks like drugs.
What is it?
It'd just be Ven's ashes, wouldn't it?
No.
Oh.
It's like it's a bag. It's a bag with like and he opens it a little bit and it looks a little dusty. He's like,
oh, is this the cathadium dust?
No.
It just looks like a little bag of sand, though. Am I looking at the wrong thing?
It does not look like sand. It looks looks a little...
Sam, if you know what this is, can you message me so I know what's going on?
I have a
don't know
thought.
What's going on.
Maybe Druk could just tell us what it
yeah,
is.
Yeah, so I know
oh, is it
if I need to rule
incense
anything.
Is it the incense and powdered diamond?
No.
No? Sam, why
message
do you have so many
please
things?
Please break the mystery.
Message okay. Justin.
Oh, that was okay.
Sam probably
what
knows
it
what it
okay,
is,
yeah,
but
yeah, yeah.
Like,
yeah,
Drug,
I forgot.
Drug
I
doesn't.
So do I. Okay, cool. We're good. We're good. We're good.
Yep.
You two.
I think
don't
I forgot to list it.
But
actually,
the two of you
stuff.
Do not know what it is, then.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I know what it is. Okay.
I mean, should I check it out? I mean, I can figure out if it's magical. It might be more euphoric to us that Ben's just been hiding away from us.
Who knows? It doesn't look quite the same, but
it might be
could
a different,
be a different brand. Manufacturer.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. So I'm gonna start ritually casting detect magic.
Okay.
With what spellcasting focus?
Yeah, with what spellcasting focus? You don't have any. Just a reminder:
uh-oh.
None of you can cast spells right now unless you have a ways to do so. No spellcasting right now, because you don't have any of your components. You don't have any of your focuses.
Yeah.
You're all just bathrobes and sandals. So,
I don't
yeah.
need a material component for
you need a spellcasting focus to you need something to channel your magic through. However, your druidic magic does require a focus still. Or components, yeah. So if you don't have either of those, you can't cast spells. Just saying, can't cast spells.
Oh yeah.
You got this fine sand, you got this fine dust in a container. Looks like there's enough for one use.
Y'all are gonna fucking die.
I don't know, Druk. Just going through Ven's things like that. Even if he is hiding drugs from us, I feel like he hid it for a reason, because I'll be the first to admit that we probably have a problem.
What? Are you kidding me? You're... Okay.
Well, I know I introduced sounds the like... us to, you know, no. Euphoric Dust, but...
Can I?
Yeah, Druk. Yeah.
If I'm going to be honest, it sounds like you're the one with the problem, not me.
Druk.
Yeah.
You've been friends for how long? Listen.
Yeah, listen to me. 74 days.
We've known each other for a little less than 3 months. And already, we have consumed multiple kinds of drugs within those 72 days. I haven't had drugs since I was 16. I've been clean since then. And until I met you, I'm not saying it's a bad thing, but I feel like we are both enabling each other
to this behavior. To be fair, you bought drugs with Dawn and Druk was nowhere near. Just saying.
Got that good elven's here.
Just saying.
Yeah, but Dawn's gone.
Yeah.
And let's be honest, Dawn was also part of this enablation.
I love it. I love it.
Enabling. I'm not the most educated druid. So maybe it's not the best idea to snort this mystery substance in a secluded room by ourselves when no one knows what we're doing.
See, I thought that was the best way to go about it.
Maybe, can we, like, at least tell someone, hey, if we're not out in an hour, come get us?
Alright.
Can we have at least a safety net? In case this shit, you know, like, we huff it and we die?
I mean, maybe. Yeah.
I know. Yeah.
So.
Kenna, yeah, that's a great idea.
Mm-hmm.
Alright. I'm gonna, stick my head out the door. I'm gonna look back in. Hey, who should we tell? Should we tell Ricky? Who should we tell? I'm stuck between Flitz and Quoin.
Quoin is swimming laps
and. And just so you know, the door from the pool is about a 30-foot distance.
All right. I think Flitz is our go-to. I think we should tell Flitz. Flitz should be in charge of our safety.
What's Flitz doing? Okay, so you open the door. What's Flitz doing?
Yeah. What is
Flitz doing? Flitz is making sure that everybody's comfortable. He's that kind of like, he's trying to set the mood, set the tone a little bit, seeing that Quoin is doing Quoin's thing. He's with Dax and Ricky trying to get them like, hey, you just settle in, you just let your worries and your fears and your doubts and all that. Oh, and Dax's mom too, because yes, she is here as well. Just trying to like walk them through, trying to like get them in the mindset. But he's like just kind of floating a little bit in the water.
You know, Flitz has got a real peaceful vibe right now. I don't want to mess with that. What about Dax? What is Dax doing right now?
Dax is talking to their mom and just suggesting, like, why don't we go see what's behind the other doors before we get
to... why don't we... I can go get your father and he can join in. He's still at that house, right? Where is he?
I don't know where he is. Okay, well, that's not entirely true. We were on Remnant, the other continent, and long story short, we did some good things, and the king, everybody, he was handing out gifts for everybody, and he gave me a deed to a house there for you and father to live in, and a substantial amount of gold, and I did send it to him because this was during the time that you were not with us.
So he's somewhere else.
I believe he should be in Remnant, but I sent him a letter, but I just haven't heard back from him yet.
Okay.
Okay, Dex and their mom seem to be, you know, reuniting. I'm gonna look over to where Riqui. What's Riqui doing?
Riqui is just sitting there on like a chair off to the side, just smiling, jazzed to be there, but doesn't really know what to do, so he's just kind of hanging out.
Hi. Oh, okay. Yeah. Hi.
So, just to let you know, so that someone knows, Dark and I are going to be in here. If we don't come out in like an hour, get Quoin and
Drek's come in here. Drek's already in there, and he's like, kind of while they're away, Drek is like,
wait for me, Drek. So, set your watch for like an hour.
I'll just sit and count.
Yeah, count for,
oh my god,
60 times 60.
Yeah,
and if we're not out by then, go get Quoin to help us, because we might be dead. And I close the door.
This is an adventure.
After
they close the door, he's just like, oh, this must be an adventure. And, they're undercover.
When you guys close the door, because these are solo massage rooms, you get a sense they are soundproofed as if to make it relaxing inside. So you can't hear anything going on outside.
Great. All right, Jack. I think we're good.
Three.
The only thing that I'm worried about is I'm not sure how we're supposed to consume this. It seems a little aerosol, like it, you know, dusty. Might need to inhale it. I don't know.
I mean, I'm gonna stick my pinky in, get a little.
Okay, it doesn't taste like anything. No, you don't feel anything.
I don't think you can eat it. I'm gonna try to scoop it up.
Okay. I'm
gonna sniff it.
Like up into your nostrils.
Yeah, Druk is right there. We're almost touching noses. So are like you sniffing it?
Smelling it? Just getting like a whiff. And maybe get a little closer and go.
Okay. It doesn't smell like anything either. So yeah, Kenna does a huge snort out of it. What about Druk?
Gage. Snort. He'll gauge their reaction.
Kenna, Constitution saving throw.
Alrighty.
If it looks like there's anything.
Also, enough for one use, but I'll say because you're just going, you're not.
Yeah.
You know.
Sorry, I had to turn off beyond 20. Roll. There we go. 13?
Druk. Kenna looks fine for a few seconds. Kenna, you start sneezing uncontrollably. And because of that, you can't breathe and are suffocating. Just, Druk, you see Kenna just sneezing uncontrollably.
Oh, wow. That means it's good, right?
You keep sneezing.
That means it's... Yeah, okay.
Again, soundproof room. Nobody can hear what's going on inside.
Oh, yeah.
Nobody can hear what's going on outside.
12.
Druk, you're also sneezing uncontrollably and are also suffocating. And also, both of you are incapacitated.
Great.
So you're both, like, in here. But no one can hear the sneezing from outside.
Oh, yeah.
What are both of your con modifiers?
In spa, no one can hear you. Also,
Even with your plus ones from the benefit, doesn't succeed. So, Druk, you can breathe for 3 minutes before you start dying. What's your con modifier?
Plus 3.
So you both got 3 minutes. All right. You can roll again at the end of each of your turns. So both of you con saves again with the plus one from the benefit. You are incapacitated, so just as a heads up, you can't take actions or reactions.
Mm-hmm.
Natural 1.
You're still, sneezing uncontrollably.
12, yeah.
Still sneezing uncontrollably. So this is gonna be 30.
My sinuses are clearing out though.
So this is gonna be 30 rounds, right?
Oh god.
Oh, yeah, we should probably keep track in case we just roll 30 without
it. I got it. So you're both alright, 29 left. Alright, con saves from both of you.
Alright.
If you two die, brutal. This...
yeah.
15.
Nothing. That's okay. 11.
Kenna, you're still suffocating. Druk, you snap out of it. And you just sneeze out the... Yeah. We'll say there's no more of this dust left. It's all gone.
Just like the dust is like coagulated in the snot.
Yeah, so Druk, you sneeze it all out. And Kenna is still going at it. So next round again. So because it's your action to try to... At the end of your, at the end of your turn when you do the save. Yeah. So
18.
Okay, you also sneeze it up. God, if you both died from that, that would have been fucking hilarious. Because no one left in the party can do resurrections.
Yeah.
Nope. So the two of you do this dust. It's all gone. There's none left.
And then I'm a little lightheaded. Are you lightheaded?
You don't. Yeah. You don't feel. Great.
I mean, yeah, you would be sneezing that much. You'd be really
You sneezed uncontrollably for 18 seconds straight. Drug for 12 seconds straight.
Yeah.
Wow.
So yeah, super lightheaded because like suffocating and passing out. So actually, yeah, you would get a little high off of that because of the oxygen deprivation. Wow. But it's all gone. That item can be deleted.
I feel like my sinuses are clear.
I mean, it's honestly not the worst time, man.
Fun fact, if they never succeeded on their saves, Lesser Restoration would have been one of the only other ways to fix that. But anyways, yeah, you see...
wouldn't have been signaled in for like
an
hour. No, because
it's soundproof too, right? So it would have been like 10 hour later. Both of them dead in there.
Alright, that was alright, I guess.
Just trying to convince himself.
Yeah. The container would be the same container that Ven found it in. It's a little head that's like this.
Oh, like a shrunken head. Yeah. Shrunken head?
Yeah, and the dust is stored inside where the nose comes off.
I mean, yeah.
None left.
I think we should stay away from it in the future.
Well,
you definitely learn it's not a drug.
Yeah.
I think.
But we're all trying to. But we're both kind of like.
Yeah.
Bit prideful at this, so we're like, we know, but we're just like. All right.
Kenna, with your history of like chemicals and that, you would know this is definitely not a drug.
Yeah. I should have I should have known better.
It was still good though. I'm feeling better after that.
I don't think I even have any uncles here.
Not on you, because that would be in your change room.
Yeah. No more drugs. I'm gonna get back in the bath.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah.
As you're in the room,
make sure that
the gnome appears on the table. Anybody want a massage?
No, I'm good, thanks.
He's like, something smells weird, and then he disappears.
Actually, I'll take the massage.
Oh, he appears again.
Alright, yeah.
I got the strongest hands.
Prove it.
He just slams you down on the table.
Okay.
Face up or face down?
What am I...
He like leans over. Do you want to look in my eyes?
Face down.
Alright, Kenny.
I'll leave you to it. Close the door behind.
Alright. Where are you most uncomfortable?
Upper back.
Climbs up onto the table, starts jumping up and down on your back. And then kneading with the hands. So, where are you from?
We're on Forest.
Me too.
He's fucking rolls.
Sorry, I don't know how to make small talk. I'm not actually from there. I'm from Holly Shire.
Oh, like Like Flitz.
Flitz? Sounds familiar. So, you got a lot of adventurers coming through here. What have you done of renown? Just curious. Yeah, he like pushes your head down and starts like massaging your neck.
Well, I don't know what we've done that's renown. That's not for the. Not something the adventurers would know.
It's anything you want to brag about? He's like massaging your ribs. Nah. Starts massaging your ribs. I'm gonna see if it's ticklish for Druk. Starts massaging the ribs.
Oh, well. We killed some coven of hags.
That's cool as fuck. What massage oil do you want? You actually have a lot of hair.
This doesn't matter. Yeah, this is.
Do you want an oil for your hair?
I don't know. Do I?
I don't know. What smells do you like?
I like lavender. Lavender smells good.
Okay, you hear a like someone's squeezing on a squeeze bottle in here, and then just backs into like rubbing into your back.
As hard as this guy is like digging
in. It feels like this gnome's got a strength of like 20. Just
yeah. As hard as they're digging in, the mix of the smells and like the pressure,
mm-hmm.
Druk's probably
out
like a light. Yeah.
All right. Hey. Oh yeah. Just keeps going. What's everybody else doing? Druk, you gain 18 temporary hit points.
I step out and I sit like at the edge of the bath for a while, and then I hear Ricky counting somewhere.
523, 1,000, 524, 1,000, 525, 1,000, 526. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, you're back. Oh, okay. All right. Yeah, okay.
You can stop now.
Okay.
Actually, get over here, Ricky.
All right.
Just ordering this kid around.
Get over this bossy.
Get over here. Get over here, new guy.
Hey, what's up?
So since you're arguably a fan of ours.
Oh, I definitely am, yeah.
You definitely are. I just thought we could have, you know, one nice conversation, you know, mouth to Ricky.
Yes. That sounds so dirty.
That sounds real. That sounds
real bad once I said.
That sounds like the episode title.
Mouth to Ricky.
Mouth to Ricky.
So if you have any burning questions, this was probably a good time.
It's like one of those things where someone asks you like what your favorite food is and you forget what all foods are.
Liver and onions.
Yeah, what did that chocolate taste like to you?
I think it tasted like chocolate. I don't know, I've never had chocolate before.
Chocolate's great.
Yeah, that was really good. Are there any? So I've only heard of your adventures that are like public, like things like that the Wayfarers Guild would have records of. So are there any adventures you've had that like people don't know about?
I mean, we've done a lot of work through the Wayfarers Guild. You know, I'm not supposed to tell people this, but because you're such a big fan, and I know you won't tell anyone else,
uh-huh.
We actually did a job for the King of Remnant.
Wow. What did you do?
So there was a plot by his nephew, right? No, was it his nephew or his uncle?
Cousin.
Cousin. There was a plot.
I like the idea of kind of getting it wrong, though.
and then coin over from the bathroom being the
one. Cousin! There was cousins.
Right,
it was
the
cousin that we cut down. Well, we didn't.
Well, spoilers!
I'll let you tell it. Just back to backstroking. The wings are helping him backstroke.
So, his cousin seemed like a real nice guy, but I knew the second I met him, he was kind of shady. But you know what? He was like our intermediary between us and the king. And I just go and tell Ricky a very elaborate retelling of how we saved the King of Remnant from an assassination attempt.
And every, like, you know, 30 seconds of the story. Yeah, that's right. He gives us the crook's eye.
I make sure to elaborate on how awesome Druk was, not missing a single shot.
Mm-hmm.
That gets rid of the whole awesome part of the fight, right?
Yeah. I also mentioned how I turned into a giant owl, and how Dex sprinted up the stairs, and how Quoin also flew up there, and how Ben cast the sphere on the king to keep him safe. And yeah, you know, we saved a whole king country that day. It's pretty awesome.
Oh, that's incredible. Yeah, that fits. That makes sense. I mean, like, with the rest of your adventures, that's wow, though.
Yeah. It's probably the one I'm most proud of.
That's really cool.
So, what about you, Ricky? What's your story?
I mean, I don't really have much of a story. I mean, I'm from Argent, mm-hmm. you know, and I grew up there all my life. Never really left. Don't really know much about the world. But then about 4 days, was it 4 days ago?
I think it was five.
Let me check it out.
Four or five days ago?
I think it's five.
Yeah.
5 days
ago, however many days ago it was, suddenly I found myself able, I told you earlier, like I felt weird, I felt like...
Puberty. You went through
I don't...
Puberty.
Sure, yeah. And then
yeah,
I...
Five days.
Yeah. And so, like, I told the elders about it, and they were a little hesitant on me leaving, but then when you came through and, like, I don't know, something about that, they, and I'd mentioned that, like, you know, I wanted to talk to see you and talk to you and stuff, and I thought you may maybe know something about what, like, maybe happened. And I guess they just finally gave in. They gave me a few, they gave me some supplies for the road. I can tell you, they told me not to tell anybody because they would get stolen, but some magic items. And then, along with, like, just some supplies, you know, some general, just my backpack, and then just sent me on the road.
Just like that?
Just like that. Well, to come fight. I mean, they sent me. They sent me through a tree.
Teleported you. Yeah.
Yeah.
So, prior to 5 days ago, you weren't, you know, leaping off buildings and punching things so hard they died on impact?
No. No. No.
Are you able to punch something so hard it dies on impact now? Have you tried that part?
Don't know. I've never tried.
You want to try right now? Mm-hmm. And I just point to my upper arm.
I couldn't.
No, go for it.
No,
yeah.
I couldn't.
Do it. Try. Go ahead. I can take it.
Well, I mean, you are really strong, so.
I've survived 2 dragon attacks, all right?
You also got one shot by Dax.
Mm-hmm.
No, well,
yeah,
that's because
it was one shot.
I got taken out by dragon breath. So technically it wasn't a one shot. Yeah. It was just a brutal critical after being hit by a dragon breath.
So Ricky, are you gonna punch?
Okay.
Unarmed strike.
Yep. I need to make an attack roll?
Yes you do.
Okay.
You can have advantage.
It's gonna hit. I'll say it's gonna hit because of kinda letting it hit. This is gonna just determine based on how well it hits.
Well, it was a 24 to hit. Roll damage?
Yes, please.
I'm about to get dead armed.
Knocked out.
8 points of bludgeoning damage.
it hurts.
Ow. 8 points?
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Yeah, 8.
Yeah?
Yeah. On a normal person, that's a KO.
That's almost a KO, yeah.
Yeah, commoners have like 9 hit points. Yeah, 9 or 10.
It hurts when I touch it.
It's like already.
Oh, are you okay? Oh, I'm sorry.
No,
I'm sorry
fine,
about that.
It's fine. It's like turning into a giant.
It's all right.
Like,
yeah.
Bruise. Oh, it's fine.
Oh, that doesn't look good. Oh, I'm sorry.
No, I've had worse. It's fine. It's fine.
Are
and
we
I can't
playing
Quoin
in the green mask, eyes really wide. Like, are we going to play the dead arm? Are we dead arming? Is that what we're doing?
Actually, I have a better idea. I think we should introduce our new friend to a game of oyster bowl. Trying to distract myself.
You don't
from
have any of your oyster. You don't have any of your oyster bowl stuff.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
The dust. Yeah, the dust was small enough for Druk to like.
Yeah, we can't
you
carry
know.
In a giant oyster
oh, yeah.
bowl.
Maybe
yeah, Druk would have hidden that under his towel. Like,
no, maybe that is something that is in another part of the spa facility.
Oyster
I mean,
bowl
it is,
room.
It is all sorts of rooms that are meant for relaxation. Maybe there's a
game room.
Yeah, or there's a room that yeah that you engage in very relaxing. What is the other room?
Oh, in there?
Yeah, because you had been in one room, and then I think I saw Dax and
yeah,
their
cool.
mom go to the other room.
Well, in the room that Druk and I were in, there was a massage table. Druk's still in there. I wouldn't be surprised if he fell asleep.
That sounds about right. And what
I mean, you get the right person with the right touch, like, it'll knock you out.
Hey, Flitz. Are we relaxing correctly? Are we spotting?
Yeah. You massage. Well, punching people in the arm doesn't really.
Yeah, I can't feel my arm
vibe
right now, but I'm fine.
You should be hitting. Maybe don't do that. That throws it all off. But that's all right, I guess.
So Quoin is gonna go. Oh, okay.
Hey, Ricky, get my other arm so at least it's equal.
Okay, are you sure?
Yeah, I'm sure. Do it, bud.
Okay.
Make an attack roll.
All right.
Not gonna.
That one is a 19.
Yeah.
9 points of bludgeoning damage.
Oh.
With the left this time.
It's even worse.
It's just a blur. Like it's just a blur. Just like, and then just like it's one of those things. Like the hand is already back in position, and like the arm is still like rippling from the hip by the time his hand is back to position.
Ricky, I think you. Never mind.
Sorry, you. I mean, you. Are you okay?
It's good. Yeah. No, it's weak. It's equal now. If you. They're like equally numb, so yeah, I can relax like this. And I go sit down on like a sauna chair.
One of the ones that's near like the hot stones in the basin, water basin.
Yeah, I just let my arms hang limp for a minute. If we, oh no, yeah, that's all for me.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool. Oh, Druk, you're still passed out.
All right.
I assume. Anybody else? Dax, we haven't heard from Dax in a hot minute, so.
Dax and their mom would have like walked around and then like poked their heads in to see like what the other two rooms on the right.
Excellent.
Were. Obviously, catching up, seeing like what's happened.
Your mom seems a little sad. About the news about her husband not being here, so she's kind of distracted a little bit by that. You open the door in there, and it's mud baths.
Do you want to try this? Do you want to see what's in the other room first?
I'm not too sure. Why don't you take the lead?
Yeah. And Dax will just, like, close that door and then just go see what the other one is.
Like the one beside this one?
Yeah.
It's another mud bathroom.
Another mud bath. Okay. They'll, like, go into it and they'll, like, gesture for, like, their mom to come in, too.
Okay. She does. It's just a simple, like, 20 by 20 foot room with a sunken mud bath in the middle. It's slightly bubbling a little bit.
I can't say I've ever been in one of these. And Dax, like, puts, like, their foot in first and just, like, feels, like, the temperature.
Yeah, it's like, it's warm mud and there's kind of, like, a suction motion to it.
I guess Dax, like, placed, like, the bathrobe and everything so it doesn't get too caked in mud to the side. They're just gonna, like, get in there. They're glad that they put their hair up. Oh, this is quite cozy. Here.
It's very relaxing. I need you to make a constitution saving throw to see how long you stay. You're not gonna drown in the mud, but this is gonna just see how long it takes them to, like, kinda put you to sleepy sleep land.
Nat 20 for 28.
You're not tired at all. Oh, maybe I'll try. And your mom climbs in. And then just... Oh, this is nice.
It's very nice. Dax is just, like, looking at her mom, seeing her, like, nod off, and she's just, like... She has had the biggest smile on just, like, having her mom back.
Alright.
And, like, obviously her mom's, like, asleep. Like, she's not waking
Your
up.
Your mom's, like, really relaxed to the point of, like, yeah. falling asleep.
Just, like, not knowing if her mom could actually hear. She's just, like... I don't actually know if Dad went to Remnant, but... Maybe he is in town. I don't know. I'm sorry that I haven't really sent you and Dad letters over the past while. It's just been really chaotic.
That's okay. They're just letters.
But they're the only way to contact the two of you, and I miss that.
That's not true.
It's not very easy to come and visit the two of you.
People have magic. It's easy to say hello.
I haven't spoken to Thranos about either in a while, and... A lot of shit's gone down between the two of us, not gonna lie.
I know.
I guess I should still say hi to him, shouldn't I?
Probably.
Well, after our nice time here, we're getting the VIP experience tonight, which I don't know what that's about.
Should just be for you. I think I'm gonna go sleep. I haven't slept in a long time.
You were in a little bit of forever sleep, but that's a... Yeah. I'll make sure to... stop by the guild. Maybe Dad did send a letter back. I don't know. Or maybe he is in town. I don't know.
Maybe.
I just hate seeing you sad.
Oh, it's quite alright. I didn't expect him to linger. He's not the type.
Hopefully he's just making the house cozy.
We were having a fight anyway before it happened, so it's alright.
You know, when Bahamut came through that rift and scared the ever-loving shit out of me, I would say I would hunt him down and, you know, give him a couple pieces of my mind for doing that to you. But I probably shouldn't. That's not the way.
What are you talking about?
You said you two were in a fight. I don't...
Nothing that requires that sort of response.
Dax, like, goes up next to her and just kind of, like, puts her head on her shoulder and is just, like... enjoying, like, the moment with her. Just kind of like, okay, Mom.
Alright. At this point, Druk, you're woken up to ear massages.
Ooh.
Like, with the knuckles, like, in the ear cavities, just...
So kind of like, that's good, but a bit too intimate, I think.
That's fair.
How long was I out?
About an hour.
An hour?
Yeah, short rest. Short rest if you want it. Everybody gets a short rest if they want it.
Oh wow!
I'm gonna roll some hit dice.
Druk's gonna make sure everybody's still there.
Yeah,
Thank you.
Yeah, everyone would still be doing what they were doing.
All right. Well, hopefully you didn't say anything too embarrassing about me to Ricky.
Looking at Kenna.
Drugs talking to Kenna.
No, I might have embellished though. I told him about our fight with the King of Remnant's cousin.
Ooh.
in the hall.
Oh yes.
Yeah.
That was a shining point for our group. Yeah. I didn't really have to do anything, and all I really had to do was keep him distracted, and we succeeded. It was all on you. I was very proud of the group that day.
Yeah, that was a good day for us. Yeah. But I did tell Ricky that you didn't miss a single shot.
Okay.
I also didn't tell him what you were aiming at, so.
Yeah. I guess we'll go with that one.
Yeah.
Anybody else doing anything? Otherwise, we're gonna do a little bit of a fast forward because it's just.
I guess Druk would probably approach Ricky.
Oh, hello.
So you said that you've enjoyed, you know, songs sung of us and tales told.
Mm-hmm.
What have you heard about each of us specifically? Like, what would you say you know about me?
I know you're a very talented woodsman, survivalist. I know that you can. I mean, a little bit of poetic license to say you could like sneak up on the wind itself. But like, you know, someone may have said that. I might have said that at one point. But you know, after reading some things, and that you're, you know, you can hit a bullseye from like a mile away.
Wind itself. You know. I don't have it on.
Every time he is in a foot race, he could pass the wind.
Yes, you know that I do have a crossbow that struck the moon, so to speak.
Oh, that's got to go in a story or something. That's really good. That's really cool.
Wait, are you making this into like a narrative?
Me? No. I just listen and read everything. I'm not talented like that.
Kenna next. Do Kenna. What have you heard of Kenna?
Kenna? I mean, like the you know, nature's fury personified. Also some things about like, you know, having such mastery over nature that even death itself heeds your command.
I mean, it's true. I have died.
Wait.
I did die once. Yeah.
How do you think that got out? That you got the stuff.
You mean my mom? Oh, hey Ricky, you want to meet my mom?
Yeah, sure.
I summon my mom in our ghost form.
Yeah, you see this decaying spiritual form of a humanoid woman.
Ricky, okay. This is my mom.
I rolled myself a wisdom save to see if to see how Ricky would react to that. And just flinches for a second. Oh! Very just, like, nice to meet you,
tilts
ma'am.
The head.
Ma'am. How do you do?
She doesn't really talk, but she's very good at giving directions and making sure that you don't fall or die. She's pretty helpful with that.
Okay. All right.
Hey, Mom, you wanna relax?
Doesn't do anything.
All right.
But now your mom's... There's just a ghost in here now.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Quoin next. And Druk slides into the water and everything. Just kind of like really starting to get in with the situation.
Quoin is... I know he's a stalwart champion of Bahamut. And healer of the sick and injured, whose skill with the sword is only matched by his valor.
That's true, and I also...
He's the tallest kobold I've ever seen.
I'm pretty tall.
I mean, yeah.
I am a giant among kobolds.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know many kobolds, but you seem pretty tall, yeah.
Oh, when I raise both hands, I'm taller than a yardstick.
Weird flex, but okay.
Yeah. Dang. All right. Now, Dax.
Friend of the Illithids from Coral Cove, I think is what it's called. The place is called. I don't get out much. Powerful titan of strength whose rage can cleave mountains.
Wow. Dax, did you hear that?
Dax is in another room.
Dax is in,
All right. This is all good.
And he kind of looks at everyone that's in this room and then looks back at Ricky.
What of Ven?
Oh! I heard that he is a wise and powerful master of the arcane and that our Mathnin himself, or he has the ear of our Mathnin himself.
If you spread any more such tales, you should also add that he is the best person.
Okay, all right.
He's the best.
And what have you heard about Dawn? Our temporary party member. You might have heard one or two stories about him in our...
Oh, yeah. Really?
No, the real Bone Daddy.
I'll message you what you would have heard about Dawn.
Oh, okay.
It's pretty non-existent.
If we give you a description, you might have heard tales of, like, someone, like, teleporting all around the city.
I sent it to you,
Sarah.
Okay. The poor soul who got teleported to death.
I know that he had an impeccable fashion sense, and there was something about an accident. I didn't hear too much about it, though.
It was a teleportation spell gone wrong.
Hmm.
That did him in. He got a bludgeoned to death against almost every building in Anundiel City.
Oh, wow. I didn't know teleportation could be so dangerous.
Yeah.
It was... I mean... We're all kind of lucky.
He turned his bones into powder.
Powdered bones.
Bones became powder.
Great fertilizer, though. But we won't let that happen to you, Ricky.
Is anyone else's mask starting to get hard?
You were supposed to wash that off.
Oh, really?
Yes.
After about 2 hours. This is, we're at like the hour and a half point.
Oh. Starting to feel like it is hard.
Oh, when it gets to what it does is it dries. Yours is probably going to take a little bit longer because you use the entire container if there was an end to it. But it gets hard, it like tightens your skin. And then after it gets like a nice, it goes like a darker shade color, you just simply wash it off, wash it away. And you have nice, smooth, clean skin.
A question for Quoin. Has like the back half of your head been washed clean by the spa bath?
Oh, yeah,
probably. Yeah,
absolutely.
It's just a sheer line.
I was backstroking. Yeah.
So it's just like...
So he's just holding his head up and doing backstroke.
Well, yeah, well, I mean, there's the wings too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Give a little bit of thrust there above. And like he's breaststroking if he's going front. Mm-hmm. So his face is trying to follow. It's still, I'm losing some. It's not great.
Yeah. The under chin is really bare.
A little, just a little. There's still a little bit. It's not a 1-to-1.
Yeah, anything really else?
Flitz. It's just, I asked if we were doing spying. What are you doing spa-wise? What would you do if this was one of your spa days? What would you do?
Well, we didn't really have all of this, so this is a lot, but you know, we kept it very simple. We did the mask. We usually did like hot towels, warm baths that you like. You had some wizards would create the water, and then you would heat up the water. You know, it was so you didn't reuse water anyway. But other than that, I mean, I think there's more to this place. But to be honest, I not really too enthused to go see butterflies anytime soon. So if y'all want to go wander around, I'll just kind of float about in the
Well, I was thinking we could maybe show Ricky the game of Oyster Bowl if we could find a games room.
Do they have one of those? Marcuccio
appears in here. Like in the you'd be summoning him in the bath, so he's in the bath.
He has a shower cap on.
He's standing on the water. He's standing on the water.
Oh!
Whoa!
Do you have a game
with shower cap on?
With shower cap on.
Do you have a game?
Are there little holes for his horns?
Yeah. We don't got a game room. We got other rooms though.
Is there one that like? Sorry. Yes, Kina, you're the
master. So there's like no place where we could find a Oyster Bowl game set.
Usually, no, not here. That's more of a tavern activity where boisterous things happen. This is more of a calming, relaxing place.
Would it be taboo if we brought our own set in here?
Yes. No right. Inside belongings, remember? Or outside belongings.
Like... All right.
It's like us having cell phones.
But. We do have activities you can do as a group here, if that interests you.
We up for some group activities, y'all?
Should we get Dex?
Yes. Let us... I'll go run and get Dex.
I should warn all of you. The massage is alarmingly relaxing.
Yeah, each massage takes about an hour.
Is it like a group massage area?
No. All private. And you can also pay extra for certain other massages, but we don't talk about that.
Dex?
Mrs. Dax's mom?
Are you going into the room, Quoin?
No, I'm knocking.
Do we hear the knock?
You do, because your constitution's so high you don't pass out.
Quoin?
Mm-hmm.
You can come in.
You see a 20 by 20 foot room, mud bath takes up the entirety of it. Dax's mom is passed right out in it.
Do you want to join us? It's quite nice.
Oh, that seems like a nice... This is the cleanest I have ever been, and I feel like it would be uncouth to ever... It seems so nice. I was going to ask if you wanted to join us. We are going to do a group activity, I think, and I wanted you to be able to weigh in with us.
That's fine, Dax. You can go with them. I'm gonna go back to the house and...
Oh, okay, yeah, I'll,
sleep.
I'll come back by the house later, okay?
Okay.
Dax just leaves, like, just plants, like, a little kiss on her mom's forehead.
Just mud.
Dax is gonna, like, just, like, not try to disturb her, just slowly gets out. Quoin.
Mm-hmm.
How does mud come off?
If it were me, I would run and jump into the pool. But also, I don't know if you could, because you probably can't beat me in a foot race. And then... like, pushes off of Dax and then starts running the 30 feet to get in.
Quoin would get there first because Dax is like submerged in mud.
Oh, I didn't
know. Can't beat me.
Yeah, so the mud's difficult. The mud's difficult terrain. So yeah, Quoin would get there first. Just
Dax just like shakes their head. Just they just kind of like quietly go, "What is Shio?"
Yeah.
To wash the mud off. Is there a separate basin, or do I just go soak in the communal tub?
The communal tub?
I just wanted to make sure I wasn't going to contaminate it.
Oh, that water seemed far worse. Blood?
Like, a lot?
People come in here to clean themselves after a long day, so it's seen some things.
Oh.
Yep.
Oh.
Anything else?
No, thank you.
And you.
And then Dax is just gonna like slowly get out, and then just kind of like gingerly grabs a corner of the towel and the robe, just so it's not getting caked in mud.
Mm-hmm.
And they just kind of go towards the tub, and they put it to the side, and they just like slip into the bones.
Okay. So you all reconvene in the communal bathroom.
Mm-hmm.
Mercutio reappears because they asked, you asked about this group activity. All right. Sorry, someone was talking to me, called for me in the mud room. So group activity. Excellent. Hope you're ready for some fun. And mayhem.
More fun and mayhem than Oyster Bowl?
Oh yeah. He snaps his fingers and he's fully clothed. This way.
I don't think that's possible.
But snaps.
Nothing happens. Alright, everyone follow me. I will take you to fun. And that's where we're gonna take our break. And we'll be back in 10 minutes for the group activity.
I don't like the way it just said.
Take your break.
And that gives me a time to homebrew something during the break real quick.
Oh.
So that's what we're going to do. So we're going to do a quick 10-minute break. We'll see you all back here in 10 minutes for more of a spa day. So we'll be back in 10 minutes, everybody.
Thank you.
you're led past, you're led out of the, out of your communal bath to go to one of these activities that the Peaceful Pastures Spa and Bathhouse provides, saying that Oyster Bowl is too chaotic and loud for this establishment. That is a tavern game. So you're led down this corridor past the other private rooms. This corridor is all private rooms. And you're led to a solitary wooden door. And you can hear the sound of, like, running water behind the door, and he's like, "Welcome." And he unlocks the door, and he gestures for you all to step inside.
I head inside.
Okay. You see an indoor racetrack, but it's made of rushing water. And set at the start of this racetrack are three large wash basins. And each wash basin has a little crow's nest built into it. And it looks like these basins, three basins, two teams of two per each basin. One person steering the basin, one person sitting up in the crow's nest. He goes, "Welcome to basin racing."
Basin racing?
Basin racing. So here's how it goes. Pretty simple. You can see this track is 300 feet long of Russian white water.
Russian?
Russian. One person, you'll split up into teams randomly. One person can designate themselves to be up top. The other person steering the basin down the racetrack. You will see there are no steering wheels. You must use your arms and hands and push your basin lean. The track has been magically enchanted that every round something randomly happens in the water. Like an effect, an environmental effect. Each person in the upper basin gets a random gadget to aid them in their endeavors in this race. The first team to reach the end wins. Now, we're going to decide teams randomly.
All right.
And there's six of you, so
three teams of two, yeah.
Yeah, I'm going to figure out the teams randomly. Yeah, Ricky, you're one. Kenny, you're two. Coin, three. Druk, four. Dax, five. Flit, six. So, the first team. Who did I say was three? Coin? Yeah. Okay, so the first team is Coin and Ricky.
Nice.
I'll write that down.
Damn!
You can give yourself a team name. I really don't care. It's up to y'all.
We could be quickie.
Oh, God.
Yeah, we're quick. We're speedy. Yeah, Coin quickie sounds good.
Quickie. Team nice. Quickie? Oh, boy. Alrighty. Team quickie.
I see no problem with this.
Alright. Team number two. Reroll is gonna be Flitz and Kenna.
All right.
So Druk and Dax are the final team. Flitz and Kenna, team name.
We gotta think of. All right, Flitz, you got any ideas?
What? Dead air.
Dead air.
Oh, actually, you know what? Yeah, dead air.
That's a pretty good one.
Yeah.
All right, Druk and Dax, team name.
Bound, not broken.
What's the team name? I didn't hear it.
Go on. Say it, Brittany.
Say it, Brittany. You got it.
I didn't hear it that well.
Muted.
You're muted. Yeah.
Your headset.
Bound, not broken.
Excellent. B and B.
B and B.
All right.
Oh, B and B.
Now. All right, so out of your teams, pick a person to go up in the crow's nest. You must stay in the crow's nest the entire time.
We're D&D, aren't
you? So, to get the idea of what's going on, the person in the bottom compartment uses their action to steer the basin, and their bonus action do whatever else. Person up top, you got free reign to do whatever the fuck you want as long as you stay in your crow's nest.
All right, that's what you want.
Or any of you proficient in water vehicles?
Nope.
But I'm really good
Excellent.
At mapping things. I'll maybe it'd be easier because you could reach the water a little bit better than I could. I don't know.
All right.
Get up top.
So Kenna. Right. So Kenna's gonna be steering and Flitz is up top.
Yes.
The obvious choice. I
so
might
Flitz
say.
Is the top. Kenna's the bottom. Quoin and Ricky. Dude. Who's Rose Nest? Who's steering?
Quoin is obviously team top.
So Ricky's steering. Alrighty. That gives us Drunken Dax.
How high is that up?
5 feet.
Oh, I'll go up there.
Okay.
If needed, my arms are long enough. If needed, my arms are long enough to assist in steering.
Alright, now. So,
like Dax have an
for the top for the top members, Quoin, roll me a d4. This determines the gadget you find at the top of your thing.
Two.
You find a collection of water balloons. Oh yeah, those are called fog balloons. As an action, you can toss a balloon up to 30 feet away, and it explodes on impact, forming a 20-foot radius cloud of fog. Each creature in the cloud is heavily obscured, blinded. Yeah, just dumb fucking.
Cool.
Alright.
Yeah, cool.
Like I said, all dumb. Flitz.
Love it.
Roll a d4. If you get a 2, reroll.
3.
That's a net gun.
Aw, dang. Mm-hmm.
This contraption can fire a net up to 30 feet away. The net uses dexterity, and on a hit, the creature is restrained. The net can be broken out of with a DC 12 strength check. As an action.
Okay. So I'm not proficient in it, though.
No, it just uses your dex modifier.
Okay, so
for hits.
And
it's unlimited ammo. All these items have unlimited uses.
What's the DC say for the net?
12 strength check.
Okay.
An action to break out of. And then, Druk, roll a d4, re-roll if you get a 2 or a 3.
Okay.
Sorry, Druk.
Yeah. That's okay. That's a 2.
Re-roll.
4.
That there's a grapple gun.
Whoa!
This contraption fires 2 hooks with 1 shot. Fire 2 hooks, 30-foot reach. Onto a solid surface, and the other hook hits another solid surface you're choosing within 30 feet, using dex. Each hook uses their own attack rolls. As a bonus action, you can reel the gun. You can reel the gun up to 30 and pull something up to 30 feet towards those points. So there's potentially you could just like shoot another. It's grappling, reeling.
But with 2.
Yes, you can choose. You get to choose which point you want to get grappled towards. So you can shoot another basin and get pulled up right behind that basin, or vice versa, something else.
Okay.
Like I said, I made it up in 10 minutes, so we'll see how it goes.
That's cool.
Now, to determine how the initiative works. Like I said, the person steering the steering the basin uses their action if they want the basin to move. The basins have a 30-foot movement speed, so the person steering has to use their action to move their basin, otherwise their basin doesn't go anywhere. To determine turn order, everybody rolls initiative, and it's a shared initiative, but the total you get is determining your team's order, so you guys add both your initiatives together on your team, and that's your total. So first, let's do team one. Team Quickie. Quoin and Ricky, roll your initiatives and add them together. Dead air.
Beat that. Beat Team Quickie.
Dead air. Add your initiatives together. Roll initiative and add them.
Dirty 20.
Oh, fuck off. 10. Said 30 total.
30.
Yeah.
That'll bring us to Team Bound and Broken. Roll your initiatives and add them together.
Oh, no.
Oh, God.
All right.
Oh, no.
What's the total?
15. No. 20.
Okay, that makes sense.
Pretty simple. The rogue rolled a nat one.
Y'all's is so weighted weird. Y'all have to get your water, yeah, your weight right. Yours is, you don't, you're not offset like, by a small creature. Y'all have two big ass creatures. Yeah, the heaviest two.
Yeah.
Listen, we're two thick motherfuckers just living our best life.
The order really works if you think about the density of like how we like the weight distribution, because Ricky and Quoin would be.
If this was Mario Kart Double Dash, it'd be it'd be Bowser and DK.
Honestly,
like.
I think that's the best Mario Kart. Anyways, so all right, on the count of three. One, two, three. All right. So, Team Quickie, you're up first. So you got your personal steering, which is your action to move it. And then pop can do whatever they want.
Question really quick.
Yeah.
Do the tubs start next to land?
No. They start five feet out from land. And you're all side by side, like pressing against each other.
Okay.
I should give you some dimensions. 300 feet long.
Mm-hmm.
Let's say 30 feet wide.
Okay. Okay. All right. Because Ricky wanted to get out and do like a running start before we got going, but
nope.
Okay.
Ricky's steering.
Mm-hmm.
So you can use your action to move the thing 30 feet forward, and then your bonus action to do whatever else you want.
Alright, okay then. Because Ricky could have done something else really funny in this, but if we start in the thing, then he won't know that he can do it. Then he won't know that he can do
it. Very much like Mario Kart, you start in your vehicle.
Yep. Alright. Then yeah, he's just steering.
Alright, so and no bonus action to do anything? You just move forward 30 feet?
Yeah, just move. That's all he can do.
Do we take initiative at the same time? Or...
Yeah, you guys are doing this at the same time.
So then at the same time, Ninja smoke screen right down, right on the ground, right where we are.
All
right,
so everyone is blinded and heavily obscured immediately. Just
nice.
And then we take off.
For steering at this point, it'll be the person driving will roll a d4 to see what direction they go in.
Nice.
We're blinded, we're going to go d4 for direction.
Wait, what was the radius of the smoke?
30 foot.
20 feet.
Let me double check, I already forgot. It's a 20 foot radius cloud, so it obscures everybody.
Oh, well, so if he threw it when we started and then we went...
Yeah, you'd be out of it. But everybody else has to make a D4 when they go here. Cool. Alright, that's your turn. Oh, yeah, that's what Quoin did. Quoin,
Team
you
Quickie
have your bonus
is
actions.
Chaos.
Quoin, you have your bonus actions, too, if you want to do anything.
But
you can,
none of
you can cast spells because you don't have your spellcasting components.
Right.
And remember, everything you guys do in this race has a +1 because of the...
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, yeah.
Because of the face masks.
Oh, so our initiative should have been 33.
No. It's 31, then.
I'm going to keep it. I'm going to keep it at the
bottom. Yeah, yeah.
32. No, each of you got a +1.
Because it doesn't matter. I'm just going to keep it where they are.
Yeah, yeah.
It would be. still by 1.
Quoin, you cannot see the other teams.
Great.
You and Ricky.
Don't really have a bonus action. I'm just probably going to open my wings to try and catch as much wind as possible.
Okay.
Flap them.
Team Dead Air. So steering is Flitz. Mm-hmm. So because of this, Flitz, roll me a D4 and we'll see what direction you go in. One
no,
is going to be
steering.
No, I'm steering.
I was going to say, wait, the That's smallest right. one is steering?
So, Flitz, Kenna, Flitz is... a 1 will be straight, 2 will be to the right, 4 backwards, or 3 backwards, 4 to the left. I don't care.
Okay.
Roll D4.
4.
So you. 4 makes more sense to be backwards, right? Yeah.
Sure.
So 4, you steer it, you're like, oh, and you boom, hit the, you move 30 feet backwards. So you hit you wouldn't really move 30 feet backwards, you'd move like 10 feet backwards, and you hit the, boom, end of the track, but that is your barrel's movement for the turn, is 10 feet back. So you're starting 10 feet behind everybody else.
Can I, as a bonus action, send my mom out to in front of the quickie
You
basin?
Can't see them. Because of the fog.
But like... 30 feet ahead or 40 feet ahead because she has a 40 feet move speed.
Yeah.
And my goal is to have use my bonus action to command her to use her action to intimidate Ricky and scare him.
Let me pull up the mechanics of that.
Oh.
Immediately just Quoin, water balloon. You're immediately like,
Quoin knows my mom.
Fuck that.
But new guy Ricky driving.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
But you did introduce me.
Yeah.
True. All right, let me look at this.
It's just Mama Peshan.
Did you mark off a use of your wild chip? No, never mind. You already used your summon your mom for today, remember? You summoned her in the bathhouse, so you can't summon your mom.
Oh.
But has it been less than an hour? Or she stays for 24 hours. She can hang around for 24 hours.
I love how much you're lawyering this fun, weird game.
As a bonus thing,
I love it.
This can take forever. It lingers an hour regardless of how it's used, so your mom would be gone by this point.
Oh, she's already gone by now?
Yeah.
Dang it.
So you can't do that. No mom.
Sad. Never mind.
All right.
That's all I got.
All right. Flitz, you doing anything up top? Can't see anything, and you see your basin. You see your basin go backwards in the wrong direction, and hit
like spinning in a circle.
Yeah, and you hit the start.
Unlimited ammo. He's just gonna take a wild shot.
yeah, sure. Roll a d4. No. Try to figure out what direction you're gonna shoot, because the fog would still be obscuring the start too. Actually, so yeah, d4. Because you actually don't see your basin hit the. You feel your basin hit something solid, but you can't see what you hit.
We hit somebody.
Yeah, roll
four.
Four.
It made me get the wall.
You shoot it in the direction you're facing. And
I got him.
The net just disappears into the.
I got him.
Oh, hold on. What the fuck? God damn it!
You got him.
You hear Mercutio go. Oh, god damn it!
Oh.
Oh, sorry.
So that's your team's. So that's any bonus actions?
No, I ain't got nothing.
All right, team B&B. So driver first, as always. So you can't see. Roll a d4 to see what direction you go in.
All right. Let's see what the ship box can do. That's a 3.
3. 1, 2. We'll say 3 is right.
Let's
no
go to
left.
The right.
Left. 3's left. So you move 30 feet to the left. All
right.
So you wouldn't hit anybody, but you hit the side of the... Because it's 30 feet wide, so you hit the side of the track.
Would we be out of the cloud?
Yeah.
Yeah. So you're out of the cloud, and you can see yourselves hit the side of the track. You can see Team Quickie 30 feet ahead, and you can't see the other team.
Okay.
So that's your action, Dax. To steer it, so you didn't make any progress. You're still at 0 feet for movement. For progress.
That's okay.
Yeah. You're not losing.
I'm not losing.
Any bonus actions, Dex? You really don't have any bonus actions. All your bonus actions hurt people.
You know what? You're not wrong.
Do you?
But I'm just gonna
mind blast everybody.
Yeah, just fuck them up.
Me doing.
Dax is right just gonna point like forward, and just be like, Druk. There, I like where they're at.
All right, Druk.
I can see them.
They're 30 feet away.
Yeah. All right.
Now, I forgot to mention the reel on the grapple gun can be used. You can either reel yourself forward 30 feet or reel something in 30 feet.
Okay.
Unless it's a solid surface, you can't really reel in a wall.
Cool.
Yeah. So, it's your turn.
Yeah, I'm gonna shoot the grappling hook at at Quoin and not at them, but on their parts of the.
So the grappling
thing.
Hook.
I don't want to grapple.
It doesn't have
them,
sharpened points.
Okay. Is it like the suction
like
cup thing?
Yeah, it's more like a suction cup thing. So you could grapple somebody and up to you. You can shoot their basin though and just. Pull the basin, or it depends if you hit the basin.
Yeah.
Obviously, they'll be saved to see if they can not get pulled, but yeah.
Okay.
Just to make it fair.
Cool. Yeah, I'm gonna aim for each of their respective
parts
spots.
Okay. All right. So roll two separate attack rolls. You only need one to hit the basin, though.
All right.
It's just
cool.
D20 plus your dex modifier.
Okay. First one is
bonus action steady aim.
Is a 17 because of the plus one.
That'll hit the basin.
Okay. And then, because it's a double decker thing, right? Because someone's up top.
Yeah.
So I'll shoot another one, the other one to the upper part.
All right. D20 plus your dex.
Which is 19.
Okay. Both hit, and it's a bonus action to do the reel.
Okay.
So you need to pull yourselves forward, or you can pull them back. And it's the driver that makes the save to see if they don't get pulled.
Okay. All right. So question about that. Can we just stay connected and be pulled?
Yeah.
Like a tugboat.
No, I think instead of pulling them back, I'll try to pull us forward.
Okay. Roll a d20. Or make a what makes more sense for this.
Oh wait, hold on. Was this at our boat?
No, it's a team quick. Yeah, team quick is the one that's ahead.
Yeah.
And this hit our boat, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it was a ranged attack?
Yeah.
It hit the boat, not you.
Oh, that doesn't that it's
you know what?
It's,
yeah, it's I'll like allow five. It. I'll allow it.
Okay. should I still roll the d10 or is it just
yeah.
like
go
okay. sure, yeah. This is fun.
Okay. It's also partially finding out what Ricky can do.
Break, so.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Where is it?
I'll say if you do happen to throw this hook back, we'll figure it out.
Okay. Yeah.
I have an idea.
It was okay. 11 plus 5. I think the two hit roll was
17.
Yes, 17.
Okay, so he's he would reduce the damage by 20.
Okay.
If it was an attack.
Yeah, you catch it.
So Ricky just like hears it coming.
You know what? We will say if somebody does get hit by the thing, it does like one damage because it's just suction
okay.
cup.
Okay. So Ricky hears it coming and then just like whips around and just catches the arrow behind him. And then is just gonna like look around. Are we indoors or outdoors?
You're indoors.
It's indoor. How high is the ceiling?
30 feet.
And then just gonna I'll spend the key point for, and then throw it straight up.
Okay, make an attack roll.
All right.
D20 and just add your yeah, because it's your monk thing. So you actually roll whatever you do roll for that.
And it uses your reaction.
Fuck. Yeah.
Yeah. 23.
Okay, so it hits the ceiling.
Great.
So now you have a point grappled 30 feet up to the ceiling, and still one of these things grappled at the base of the basin.
Cool.
I don't know how I did that.
Yeah, or top of the basin because Ricky caught the bottom one. So, all right. So are you reeling?
Keep doing it. If you don't know how, but keep
so
doing
it.
So,
are you reeling in or are you reeling them back?
I'm reeling in.
Okay, we'll say because both weren't connected, you reel in. I don't know. I said you can choose which one you wanted to go towards. Yes, you still move 30 feet ahead.
Cool. You bump into him.
Yeah, you bump into the back of their thing.
Nice move, Ricky.
Thanks.
And then they both unhook and they back into the gun.
Ricky, that was fucking awesome. What the hell?
All right.
What happened?
The fog cloud is still there. For
what?
Team Dead Air. Team Quinky, your turn. They this other basin just bumps into the back of yours. So steer always goes first. So Ricky,
yeah.
You don't have to roll a d4 because you're out of the fog cloud.
Yeah, just gonna steer 30 feet ahead.
Okay. Any bonus actions?
Nope.
Okay.
Doesn't know he has them.
Quoin, you doing anything? You can see this other base and just
throwing that smoke bomb
right down
behind us,
as you're leaving.
Putting them in the fog again. Kapa!
Okay. Druk, you're sitting in your little thing and just. Cool. Team
just coin. Aha!
Alright. Team Dead Air. Roll a d4 because you're still in the cloud, which lasts. Oh, it doesn't go away. So roll a d4.
We're fucked.
Oh no.
We have
the fact that
we
got
get
this
through.
The fact that we got this and went first is incredible because it just means that like the whole track is just gonna be covered in fog.
Oh shit. I forgot to do something. Hold on.
Oh yeah, random shit happens.
Random shit happens. Someone roll a d4 for the random shit. I've missed like two rounds, so we're gonna have two go off at the same time. Delayed. He's like, oh,
I'll
sorry, I was tied up in a net.
I rolled a one.
So someone roll. Okay, a spray of water jettisons out of the walls. I need everyone to make a dexterity saving throw.
Oh no.
Add one.
And add one.
Oh no, Flitz! 19.
You're 19.
You're 20. Fine. Dirty 20.
No, Ricky.
Anyone? Who all got?
Oh, wait, actually 20 because I'm
just for the sake of my sanity. Who all got below a 15?
Sorry, it's a dex save?
Yeah. Plus one because of the benefit thing. No one got below 15?
I did. I got a 14.
Okay, Quoin, you're blinded by water as it sprays into your eyes. Just
sexy. All
right. We'll say that lasts until the start of the next round. Okay.
You don't need to see the throw down smoke bombs.
That's true. All right, and because I forgot a round, someone roll another d4. Okay. Roll if you get a one.
Oh boy.
Effects can't stack.
Oh no. Okay. Oh god. Oh Christ. Oh, there we go. Just don't be a one. Two.
Okay. A large whirlpool forms in the entirety of the track. I need the driver of every basin to make a strength saving throw.
You got this, Dax.
21.
22.
I just need to know whoever got below 15. All right, no, it's a 21.
24.
No one's things are partially are submerged underwater. All right, now we'll go back to... Team Dead Air, D4 for your direction.
Oh, wait, sorry.
I thought you said Dare.
No, Team Dead Air.
That wasn't 24. That was just, that was 20, not 24. Yeah, I added it twice.
Yeah, two?
Ricky, two. Take
the wheel. So you go.
How long do these fog clouds last?
They don't disappear.
Indefinitely.
So, two, you're currently facing backwards.
Uh-huh.
Two is left. So you go. You're out of the fog cloud now as you hit the left side of the start way, but you're still negative 10 feet behind the starting point. You're on the on-ramp, basically, so
fuck.
That's your action to steer.
Yep. I don't have a bonus action. All right,
Flitz, what are you doing? The fog cloud, you still can't... You're out of the fog cloud now. You can see you see about 30 feet ahead, or 40 feet ahead is another fog cloud that obscures that entire area of the tracks. You can't see the other teams. Yes, the fog clouds are indefinite, so there's just poof, poof.
Do anything. I can't do anything.
You guys have
we just got really unlucky.
Fog can clouds. I
Team Quickie.
Shit. Yeah, I don't
definitely
have
not.
Anything. I mean the net gun is too I can't see anybody,
can't see
so
anybody.
The net gun is useless. He's just gonna try to he sees another fog cloud, he's gonna like aim up a little bit and he's just gonna shoot it.
Okay, make an attack roll, disadvantage.
Just hoping for something. Right.
And
disadvantage.
I'll say, yeah, disadvantage, and we'll go from there.
Come. Oh, fuck off. Damn it.
No!
So it's disadvantage, d20 plus your dex.
Yeah, it's an 8. It was a 14 and an
okay.
18, and it
so,
tipped over on
team
the floor.
Quit. Team.
Dead air.
Team B&B. Bound and broken. Would hear a net. Something sail over their head.
We're coming for you!
Alright.
Hit it, do better.
So, anything else? You're still negative 10 feet behind.
No, that's it.
Hard to see down here.
Alright, that's going to bring us to team B&B. Fog Cloud, driver, D4.
I can't see much, Druk, I'm sorry. Two.
Two. Which is left. Whatever, it doesn't really matter. Those two directions don't really matter. So you you 30 feet out of the fog cloud, but into the wall again.
Cool.
Sorry, Druk.
Do we see Dax and Druk
yes,
now?
Yes, you see that come out of the fog cloud. Or no, because it's a 20-foot radius, yes. So,
okay.
Druk, the other team's 30 feet ahead.
Yeah, so... Druk sees that they've got like this smoke bomb thing happening.
Mm-hmm.
Druk's gonna try like shooting at Quoin.
Like hitting Quoin?
Yeah, and like.
Okay, make an attack roll. It's two hooks, so two separate rolls towards Quoin. Quoin, you see Druk aiming this grapple gun at you directly.
No, he doesn't see it.
I don't see a thing.
Oh, yeah, Quoin doesn't see a thing. So, heavily obscured, so the attack is still with disadvantage because it's heavily obscured.
Oh, wait. So he's still in the...
Quoin's heavily obscured, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Because you... No, because you guys moved ahead, so yeah, you can see them.
He's just blinded.
Okay. Yeah, Quoin's blinded because Quoin... Oh, yeah, Quoin got hit with this... Quoin can't see anything, so the attack is with disadvantage.
Okay. Blinded. All right.
All right. What's coming?
All right. That's good because there was a nat 1 in there. That's a 22 to hit.
Yeah. So, Quoin, you feel a one of those suction cup things hit you in the back.
Yeah, I don't have my shield, do I? Damn.
I said it only deals 1 damage, but that was just for the purpose of hit missile things, so it doesn't deal any damage.
For sure, for sure.
You get hit by a thing. Do you want to? You firing the second hook at anything?
Yeah. I guess I'll try to hit the basin as well.
Okay. That's just a straight roll.
Okay. Yeah. Natural 20.
Yep. Thunk into the basin.
Or 25.
So you can pick either reel something back or reel towards it.
I'm gonna reel them back.
So the basin or Quoin?
I can only pick one
okay. Point, yeah.
Well, if you pick both, then we both would just come back at the same speed.
Gosh.
We just get Quoin on our boat. Hey.
I don't want to get things too I don't want to get things too complicated, so I'll just roll.
Do it. Bring do them it. Both no, in. Do it.
I was gonna try and like pull Quoin because he's the one like tossing all that smoke.
I don't think we can win if both of us aren't in the tub, so.
Yeah, I
only one person
trying.
Needs to be in the tub at the finish line.
Oh, really?
But it helps if you have both in the tub.
Okay.
I mean, I would still try.
Huh. Well,
do it.
Don't
Quoin,
do
guys.
It.
Quoin can fly anyway, so he can just fly right back up on top of there. So
I have to get out of the water first.
Yeah. Do you want anarchy Quoin on your boat?
So what are you doing? What are you doing?
Dropping this anarchy.
Pulling Quoin or the basin back?
I'm gonna pull them both back. Honestly,
okay, so you're pulling
I
the
want
basin
to pull
back.
Them both. Yeah, yeah.
Okay, so steerer, strength saving throw.
Ah! All right, and it's plus one from Quoin, plus one from the things, plus two total.
Yeah, because you get plus one from Quoin's aura, and then plus one from the benefit.
22.
It does not get pulled back.
All right, still connected though, or does it?
No, it's unconnected.
Oh fuck! Oh well, they won.
Growing like crazy.
next turn, they're gonna be out of range.
It's 300 feet. We'll see what happens. All right. Start the next round. Someone roll a d4. Quoin, you're no longer blinded. The whirlpool is also gone. Someone roll a d4.
Got it. D4. So 4.
A portion of the water raceway gets a faster current. At the start of their turns, each driver makes a DC 15 strength or dex save to steer towards the current. Except for the people who are very far behind.
The opposite.
No. Everyone gets a chance to go for this, just to see if you can speed up your basin temporarily. All right. So this, the current's faster, which means falling in could also be not so great. All right. So, team. I'm trying to think. There's no one obscured in clouds anymore.
Nope.
All right. Team Quickie. The driver make a strength or dex save to steer towards the current.
Oh, dex all day.
The driver does this.
28.
Your basin gets a plus 10 movement speed.
Hell yeah.
So your basin moves at 40 feet on your action.
40 feet ahead.
My God.
Okay.
I drop a bomb.
You drop or throw it. The other team is...
Wait, doesn't Quoin only have 3?
They're unlimited.
No, they're unlimited. Yeah.
I still would if I only
had
one.
You can throw it up. You can throw it up 30 feet away. So it depends wherever you want it. You want to drop behind you? You can just toss it.
Drop it behind us.
Okay, right behind you. Obscured again. Cannot be seen.
So they, even if someone moves 30 feet ahead, they're moving into obscurity.
Yeah. Alrighty. Team Dead Air driver, make a check to see if you can speed up your thing a little bit.
Strength check for me.
It's a save.
Strength save for me. That's an 18.
You have a plus 10 movement speed to your basin. Let's see. So now
we're out of it.
You can now steer ahead 40. You can steer ahead now 40 feet.
Can I steer so that we're out of the range of the fog cloud ahead of us? Because there's like
a
10-foot
gap. Wall, right?
Yeah, on the wall.
If you skirt the wall, yeah.
Yeah, I want to skirt the wall
okay.
so we don't have to
hug them corners.
So 40 feet, you're 30 feet now.
Woo!
So you're basically...
we're only 70 feet behind the leader.
I'm just imagining you guys like, yeah. It's a late start, but you got like a Tokyo Drift coming around that corner.
Yeah. So you're 70 feet behind the leader. You're 30 feet behind B&B.
Okay, so question for the net. It's essentially shooting someone.
And they get restrained, yeah.
Perfect.
And they have to they have to use your action to break out of the net. So you can see. So yeah,
we're going for.
You guys.
We're gonna
see,
go for.
You can see. The only team
the
you
driver.
Can see is bound and broken. So you're going for the
we're
driver.
We're gonna go for Dax.
All right, with your net gun, add a d20. Roll a d20 and add your Dex modifier as you shoot the net gun at Dax.
Come on, Flitz.
15.
Dax, you're not wearing your. No one's wearing armor right now.
She
by
doesn't.
The way.
I don't think.
No,
she's
but
a barb,
I have. I'm
What's your AC?
Unarmored. Unarmored.
What's your AC?
16, bitches!
Oh.
Flitz, anything else? We've got bonus actions, Flitz.
Can you fire again on a bonus action?
No. No. Damn it. No. That's it.
Okay.
Dax just sees it go by and just looking at you just like...
All right, bound and broken. Try. You, in front of you, directly in front of you, is the cloud.
So that'd be 30.
But... Did we succeed in getting to the speed zone?
Oh yeah, it's driver. Strength or dex save at the start of your turn to see if you get the boost.
I'll do strength.
This is just you like trying to pull the barrel towards the.
Plus 14.
14 fails. Did you get a plus one from the face mask?
I did.
Yeah, so you do not get the speed boost.
Distracted by that net getting chucked at
you. Can go directly forward, though, because you're not in the cloud.
Yeah.
Yeah. So,
I will
30 feet
so
ahead.
Knowing that it's... Yeah, I'm just going to go straight
okay.
ahead.
Then you would go through right through the cloud on the other side. All right, you're... So 30 feet, you'd be 10 feet behind the leaders. So, right behind them.
Ah!
Oh shit.
Unless, hold on. Quoin, did you drop it? I gotta figure out how you dropped it. Did you drop it as soon as you moved the 100 feet directly behind you, or did you do it as you left? Like, did you do it end of movement or start of movement?
So that would have been, like, start of movement.
Okay, so yeah, the other team, B&B drops from the fog cloud.
They would move into it.
And out of it. They'd be out of it.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, they'd be just out of it. 20-foot
radius?
They'd be just out of it. Alrighty.
Nice. Now we got a match.
All right,
Druck,
so,
anything?
Yeah, can I see Flitz and
yeah.
Kenna?
They
I can?
Are...
We're Tokyo drifting.
They're 60 feet behind you. 60 feet back. this gun's only got a range of 30.
So, okay, that's
we're
the maximum.
Really far behind.
Yeah, maximum is 30.
Okay. I was gonna see if I could like shoot them and then shoot them with one end and then shoot the coin and then with the other.
You have sharpshooter, right?
Yeah.
Sharpshooter does ignore range stuff.
Not the max range.
No.
It's like the physical range of the weapon.
True. Yeah, probably not then, unfortunately.
Okay. All right. I'll shoot I'll shoot Quoin again, see if I can pull them off.
Okay, make an attack roll. You get two of them, so it doesn't really matter if, you know.
That's a 8. Nope, that's a 14 to hit, which probably doesn't hit Quoin.
No, yeah, no one's wearing armor, so.
That's a nat 1.
So, yeah,
so
both
none
miss.
Of them hit. Yeah.
Quoin, you see Druk shoot two plunger things at you, and they both miss. And you reel them back in as they're in the water.
Gosh, she's so quick.
Oh yeah, because you have to keep up to reeling them in after you shoot them.
Yeah.
So that's your bonus action used up.
Yeah.
So quick.
Oh, that sucks. All right, someone roll a d4 for the start of the next round.
I'll do it. 1.
Spray of water jettisons out of the walls. Everyone makes a dex save or is blinded. So if you're blinded, it's still a d4 to see what direction you go in.
Thank God.
And just say if anyone got below 15.
16.
Ooh. I think we all are skirting.
16.
Yeah.
Okay, so no one, the water sprays, 17. You all close your eyes in time, and no one gets blinded.
Oof.
All right. Team Quickie, driver.
Mm-hmm.
What are you doing?
Question, actually.
Yes.
Is it so? The action is it's the taking a steering action. It's not technically movement, right?
No, you
okay.
You don't have your you can't really use your movement either. You're stuck. Right. Okay. You have to stay in the basin.
Right. Okay. So something that would allow you to move as a bonus action wouldn't count for this. Okay. Then yeah, just 30 more feet.
Okay, you're 130 feet in. Quoin, you doing anything?
Mokba!
At the end,
like
of,
the least.
At the end of the movement, or as you're moving?
As we're moving, the beginning. Like
okay, right at the beginning. Like so it would obscure.
Throw it in the air. As I throw it in the air.
Yeah.
Bye bye.
So it would obscure Team Bound and Broken because they were 10 feet directly. <around. laughs>
It's just we don't really make decisions. We just like
we're coming in hot.
Just 30 feet forward, drop a smoke bomb. 30 feet forward, drop a smoke bomb. We've got a strategy.
So
it works.
So the smoke bomb is proven to be better than I thought it would be. Cool.
Mostly right. Because we went first.
Yeah. So Team Dead Air, you are very far behind.
Yes.
You can see. You cannot see. Based on the length, you cannot see Team Quickie, but you can see Team Bound and Broken 60 feet ahead.
Okay. I'm gonna keep drifting along the edge.
Okay, so 30 feet straight forward. Ahead?
Yeah.
Alright. Anything for you, Flitz?
So they're now...
Whoa, what the f-
only... They're now only 30 feet ahead of us, right?
That's so fucking... A big beetle just ran over my hand.
Oh, fuck that!
Sorry. Yeah, Flitz, they're 60 feet ahead.
Perfect. Wait.
No, they're 30 feet.
We just,
30, sorry, 30
we
feet.
Just,
maybe 30
yeah.
feet. Now, yeah.
The little. going for Quoin because.
Oh, you can't. You'd be seeing Team Bound and Broken, not a.
Wait, they're in the fog cloud, though.
Wait, unbroken. I'm confused. I keep forgetting the teams.
Quickie is the.
Quickie's in the lead.
Yeah, you see
the smoke bomb.
Yeah, that's Quoin and.
Yes, that's who he's gonna aim at Quoin because they dropped a smoke bomb on Druk and Dax B&B.
Yeah, but they might be too far away for your thing. Your thing's only 30
feet.
Well,
if it's 30 feet, I thought you said it was.
Okay, they are.
No, we're way.
They're
way
130 ahead. Feet. You guys are 60 feet.
We're 70 feet. No. Yeah. So,
yeah, they're
70
way,
feet ahead of you.
Only... Okay, so they weren't 60. Okay,
yeah.
I thought they were 60 feet away from us.
They're pretty far ahead. And that's right, you can't see the other team because they're obscured by the fog cloud.
Yeah. There's another fog cloud, though, so I'm just going to take a random pot shot. Why not? All
right. Roll disadvantage, and then if it hits, if it would be hit somebody's AC, I'll roll a die to see who it actually goes for.
13. Okay. I don't think it will.
Does anyone on Team Bound and Broken have an AC of 13?
No.
Nope.
Without. Yep, so Team Bound and Broken, here's another net. Get fired.
Don't worry, it's totally working.
All right.
What the fuck?
Get someone, Flitz.
All right. Cool. Team Bound and Broken. D4 for the driver because you're in the fog cloud.
Boy.
3.
Okay, 30 feet to the right into a wall.
Okay. Are we out of the cloud?
You're out
Druk,
of the
cloud. Get him.
Okay. All right.
So you'd be slow at 90 feet.
And how far away are they now?
From you, they would be... which team?
The...
Team Quickie?
Quickie.
40 feet.
Okay, so it's outside of the range.
Yeah.
So I'm going to aim for... some barrels that are within range and then pull us closer. Hopefully. Can I... Do I need to... I mean, I imagine I need to roll to hit to, like, a section of the raceway?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, just, like, the side? Oh, wait, yeah, hold on. The suction gun actually is the best one.
Yeah,
because
you
can
shoot the course
move
up ahead
twice.
And pull, yeah.
Yeah.
But the wall has an
full
AC.
Steam ahead, Druk.
Yeah, oh, man, I should have thought about that.
Just move, and the move.
Yeah.
Maybe to make it fair, maybe you can only shoot other people.
Well, you can only reel once, right? And.
Right, but it's still basically a double move. Yeah. Because you can move and then reel, and then move and then reel. So you can move 60 feet around.
Unless I'm blinded.
Yeah. I suppose they counter each other.
Or obscured, yeah.
All right. Mm-hmm. Yeah, go for it. Shoot the wall.
All right. All right. If I could hit...
And okay, you'd be the opposite wall, so you'd be, moving like 30 feet diagonally.
Okay. All right. 20.
I'm going to say the AC of the wall is like high, but yeah, that hits.
Okay. Cool. Real.
Okay, so you can reel ahead 30 feet diagonally.
Ah, they're catching up!
Ah.
All right, so you would be... Plus 30. Oh, yeah. Oh, man, that's a bummer. Two.
If it's diagonally, does that mean that we're next to them, or we're outside of
there? Behind them.
Okay. But I meant, like, if they do a smoke bomb, are we far enough away from them?
Depends if they laterally? Throw it. Depends if they throw it at you.
Okay, cool.
So you'd be 90 plus 30, 120 feet. So you're 10 feet behind Team Quickie.
Cool.
All right. D4 for the next round.
I got it. 4.
That's the fast current.
All right,
so Ricky, strength or dex save to steer towards the current.
Oh boy. 19 plus 2, 21.
You get to the current, so you have a 10 foot bonus.
Yeah!
So you move ahead 40 feet?
Yep.
Alright,
yeah!
Alright, so I'm in there. I'm going to throw it behind me. I think you said 30 feet was the throwing distance for these?
All the range stuff is 30 feet.
Great, I am going to throw it 30 feet behind us.
Okay, so it hits the other... We hit the basin of...
Well, I think they're 40 feet behind us, right?
At
least.
Yeah.
But if you do it at the start of your movement, you would hit their basin.
Oh, that's a good point. I'm
they're
10
feet right behind you. Yeah.
Then I am, going to hit them with 10
feet. The team bound and broken. Ah. Another fog balloon. Obscures you.
Aha!
So the current positioning.
Let's go!
The current positioning down the raceway. Team Quickie, 170 out of 300. Team Dead Air, 60 feet out of 300.
Oof. No, we're
wait, we have
to
at least be... Yeah, we had 40.
Yeah.
No, we started that round at negative 10.
Oh, that was when we started that.
And then <You're right. laughs> Team Bound and Broken is at 120. So, Team Dead Air.
Yeah.
Oh, wait. Yeah, Team Dead Air. Roll a strength or dex save to see if you can get that fast current. All
right, strength save. Nope. That's a 10.
Yeah, even with plus 1. All right. So... 30 feet forward?
Yeah.
Alright, you're at 90 feet. Anything, Flitz?
Gosh.
You can see... Oh, no! Bound and Broken is obscured by a fog cloud.
But we're in range of them now.
Yeah, you're 30 feet. You're exactly within 30 feet of where they last were, so you can try your net thing again if you want.
How far away from us are... Oh, they're so
far. They're so far away. They're 170 feet total. And you're at 90.
This is just
you're
a
at
90. Away.
You're at 90, so they're 80 feet ahead.
Oh my god. Yeah.
They're
sure. We're going to. Saw them being dragged across diagonally.
Yeah.
Going to aim at where the. He's just aiming at where the new fog clouds are.
Yeah,
here,
go for it. So disadvantage. Disadvantage. And if it hits somebody's AC, we'll see. We'll figure it out randomly. And if it hits, it hits.
That's two fucking fours.
Druck and Dex, you hear another net get fired in your direction.
You're getting better, Flitz.
I'm not.
Alright, that's Team Dead Air. Team Bound and Broken. Driver, strength or dex save to see if you get that speed boost.
I'll drive for strength.
And then a d4 to see what direction you go.
Ooh, net 24.
So you have the 40. You have the 40 foot bonus. Let's see what direction you go in. So roll a d4.
40 foot bonus.
It's 40 foot total now. Okay. So, man, if you roll a 4 and just 40 feet back.
Oh, I rolled one!
40 feet straight ahead.
Fuck yeah!
I was gonna say, I feel like since it's a current, if you went backwards, you should actually move 10 feet slower.
No.
The water actually turns
it's just
current
to increase
just
your
you.
Basin speed. Okay, so 40 feet directly ahead.
You're going
so
against the current.
40, 120, 160. So you're directly 10 feet. Dax, with your movement, you're 10 feet directly behind Team Quickie. You're at 160.
Bonus action.
Are you going to do it?
No.
It will affect Druk if you do Mind Blast.
No, that's not what they're doing. That's not what they're doing.
Mind Blast.
I don't know if I can just do this. Can they just use their telepathy on fucking Ricky and just in their mind just
Ricky.
Coming for you.
Okay, Ricky, hear Dax's voice in your mind. Okay. cool. D4 for the next round, please. Let's see what happens.
Ricky.
Gotcha.
I want Team Dead Air to win this.
4.
Reroll, because we just had that effect.
Okay.
No duplicates.
We're really just drifting at a leisurely pace.
1.
Spray of water. Psst. Everyone makes deck saves.
Damn it.
Nope.
Fell that one.
15 fail. Exactly. 15 thanks. Succeeds. Thanks 15. To it was 13, yeah. But then the right, face so mask got below 15.
Team Dead Air.
Only Team Dead Air. So everyone. I rolled
a 14 plus 1 because of the the face mask.
So everyone in Team Dead Air is blinded.
Ow!
All
right. It's like soapy water.
Dead air is it doesn't hurt or anything. It's just water. Team Quickie.
It's still surprising.
So Team Quickie.
30 feet.
So we got a team that's no longer in a fog cloud.
Mm-hmm.
We got you guys. So you guys move forward 30 feet. 200 feet. 100 feet left to go for Team Quickie. Quoin, are you doing the usual?
I'm throwing it at them. Yeah.
Yeah. So
right,
team bound and broken. Another fog cloud. All right.
There's no way.
So team Dead Air, you're blinded. D4 to steer.
Yeah.
Go forward. I guess wherever that is.
Give me a 1. Give me. That's not a 1. It's a left or a right.
Yeah. You're.
We're hugging the right wall.
I need to know what you
we?
Got because you might just. Keep you might
2.
Yeah, you're still in. You don't move.
That's a wall.
Yes, you don't move whatsoever. All right.
You go forward, but you forget that you were forward is facing the wall still.
Yeah. Flitz, you're
take a wild.
Oh wait,
pot shot.
I should be changing the direction based on how you're facing, but that's too complicated. Flitz, what are you doing?
Oh my god.
I don't think you can reach any team.
I don't know that.
So you can't see. Yeah.
Might as well. I remember shooting a direction. We didn't really change that. We hit the wall again.
Yeah.
And he's just going to aim upward in motion and just shoot.
Okay. Nope. All right. Team,
you have, like,
team bound and broken. D4 because of the fog cloud.
Two.
Okay, so into the wall. So you're still at 160.
Right. You're out of the fog cloud, though.
You're out of the fog cloud.
Yeah. We are certainly out
The other team's 40 feet ahead. They're at 200. You guys are at 160. Can't hit 40 feet.
No, ahead. I mean, not at them, but to pull us at least
on the
wall. A little competitive.
Make an attack roll.
Okay.
Come on, Druk. You got this.
So it'd be the adjacent wall.
Now. First one's a 9.
That misses the wall. Just
whoosh
in the water.
Bounces off.
The next one's a 15.
Nope. Into the water.
Okay. That's it.
It's okay, Druk. It's humid in here. They're not sticking right.
They're trying to get plungers to stick on a wet rock.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Exactly. D4 for the next round.
I got it. No. Who's doing it?
Go ahead.
Doesn't matter.
All right. 4.
The fast currents.
It is.
All right, so Team Quickie.
Everybody fail your deck
save.
Strength or deck save to see if you picked up the current.
Nat 20!
No!
Yep, you get the speed bonus, so just forward ahead 40 feet.
Yep.
You're at 240.
All right, going to just throw it right down at the ground behind us, then.
So. All right, so you're obscured. There's no one within range of that, so no one can see you. Cool. Team Dead Air. You're no longer none of you are no longer blinded. So does a strength save to see if you reach the
11?
You do not reach the speed boost.
All right, just 30 feet forward then.
All right, so you'd be at 120.
How far away are Team B&B?
Like 100 feet.
Team B&B is 40 feet away.
Okay.
The Team Quickie is like feet? Team Quickie is 120 feet away. Or no, that's not right.
Kenna.
Team Quickie is real far away. Oh, 120 feet. They're 120 feet away.
Kenna, I'll be right back. Bonus action.
What?
I'm gonna hit Flitz is what? Gonna just stand up and he's gonna jump and he's gonna bonus action use his fly speed. His elemental gift, the air just kind of picks up. Mm-hmm. And he's gonna fly 30 feet ahead and he's gonna take a shot at
fair.
Take a shot at fuck. It's the harder one. These are both hard to hit. Yeah. He's gonna hit Dax, because Dax
is. You have
is
to stay in your thing, but whatever.
The wind, help!
We're in Dax!
Okay, so who are you shooting at?
Dax.
Alright, make an attack against Dax. You don't have disadvantage on this one because you can see Dax.
Oh, fuck off. Oh, wait, 17. I rolled a 16 plus 1.
Dax is restrained by a net.
So won't Dax, be loud.
I can't see anybody else than 30 feet of me, can I?
No.
Nope.
So Dax has to use their action to break out of the netting if they want out of the netting, which means they can't steer.
What the fuck, Flitz?
We'll be last. Okay, we'll be last of
Flitz,
we'll
you go back to your position?
Oh yeah, because they were only 40,
yeah.
So I only needed to fly up
yeah.
10.
Yeah.
So yeah, he's gonna oh, and he's gonna drift back.
Since you left your post, Constitution saving throw.
Oh god.
Come on, Warlock.
19.
You're fine. You feel like a tingling sensation. You feel like a tingling sensation in your where you're positioned, and nothing happens.
All right. Please, that was great.
So team bound and broken can't steer because Dax is restrained on netting. So Dax, you can use your action to break out of the net if you'd like.
I would like to do that.
Make a strength check.
DC 12.
Just a saving throw? Or
no,
just...
strength check. Athletics.
Duh. Thank you, brain.
Plus 1 because of the face mask.
20.
Yeah, you break out of the netting, but that's your action. Druck, what are you doing? You're obscured by the fog cloud.
Oh, wait. No, we got out of that, and they just threw it behind them after
yeah.
they had already...
Yeah,
they were already 40 feet away.
Quoin said they threw right at your basin when they were leaving, so you're obscured by the thing.
But that was last turn. The turn after that, they were already 40 feet ahead.
Yeah, but you didn't succeed on... Oh, no, you moved... They didn't move out of it
last
time.
You can't see them.
Yeah, that... Yeah. With his freakishly long arms, can I, since I'm five feet up and my arms are, I can do the 10-foot reach thing? I can't, like...
Nope, because that's Dax's position on yours. Nope.
All right. Then I will use... Did Dax get out of the ropes?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. I guess I'll do a shot and see if I can reel.
All right.
Just to get closer. Yeah, because those guys are too far away anyway. All right, so a shot at the wall. Hey, 25.
Hits. So bonus action reel. Okay, so you're at 190 feet. So as of the current standing, is going to the next round. Team Quickie, 240 feet. 240 out of 300.
Woo!
Team Dead Air, 120 out of 300. Team Bound and Broken, 190 out of 300. So... D4 for the start of this next round.
I'll do it. D4, here we go. 3.
Finally, a menthol-like mist spritzes into the air. Very minty, very nice. It also makes it feel like it's starting to make your limbs lock up. I need everyone to make a con save.
Oh, no.
Oh, fuck.
No.
Aw, it was so close to a 20.
And just say if you got below a 15.
Don't forget your plus.
I rolled a 3 on the die.
Riqquarian, you're paralyzed.
7 total.
until the start of the next round. So Ricky, paralyzed. Steering, so you're a steerer, paralyzed. Mm-hmm. Kenan, what'd you get?
18.
You're fine. Quoin.
Oh, wait, hold on. Was that poison?
No.
It doesn't count as a poison?
No, it's a menthol mist.
Okay, all right, buddy. Okay, not a poison, it's just a chemical that negatively affects.
Fine, yeah, it's technically a chem. It's technically a poison. It's not. It's a chemical, but it's not harmful.
It's paralyzing.
Yeah, but not in a bad way. Yeah, fine. Ricky, you get like advantage or something, right? Or are you immune?
No, I'm immune to all poison.
All right, never mind. You're not paralyzed.
Monk.
Quoin, what'd you get?
22.
You're fine. Dex. Yeah.
17.
You're fine. Druk.
5.
You're paralyzed. Oh, fuck. To the next round. Flitz.
13.
You're paralyzed until the next round. So, are any drivers paralyzed? No. Just people who are up top. So, Druk and Flitz are the only ones that are paralyzed.
Yeah.
Great. All right. Team Quickie.
Quoin is going to throw a fog balloon 20 feet behind, so it should be around the 220 mark.
Yep. Okay, so it would obscure
they're at 190 right now. Yeah. They'll have to go into the cloud if they move their full movement
Correct.
Speed.
All right. Cool beans. Yeah. Yeah. Alrighty. So Team Quickie, 30 feet ahead. That's 270.
Yeah.
Next round.
We can taste it.
Yeah.
Taste victory, all right,
team
Ricky.
Taste minty. Only Flitz is paralyzed for Team Dead Air.
Yeah. Alright. So 30 feet. Wait, actually. So I have to use my action to steer?
No, you can use your action to do something else, but your action is how you steer and move the basin.
Okay.
Also, you don't have anything. You don't have any of your spell stuff.
I know.
Oh.
How heavy is this basin with Flitz in it?
Flitz's weight plus your weight plus 20 pounds.
30 pounds.
Minus my weight? Okay.
No, plus your weight. So 30 plus 20 is 50, so plus your weight.
Okay. One second.
Do it. Do it.
So, say I had a strength of 13.
Mm-hmm.
I could lift. I can lift 30 times my strength score. So that would be,
130
roughly pounds. 180 pounds, roughly. Okay. So I'm going to wild shape into a giant owl, pick up the basin, and fly 60 feet forward.
Sure.
Yeah, there it is. Yeah. I love it. I love it.
60 feet forward. That puts you at 180. So, Team Bound and Broken sees. Well, Druk's paralyzed. So you still see while you're paralyzed. But Druk, while paralyzed, you see this massive giant owl just flying with the basin in its talons and land 10 feet directly behind.
Oh, bless.
So that's your action.
Yeah.
That's a.
I don't know why I didn't think of it sooner.
Because you got out of the vessel.
I'm still attached to touching it.
You got out of it. Technically.
I'm just
actually,
it the
did
whole
they?
Time.
Their feet are still probably in the same spot.
Fine.
Henry Lawson asks why you're
listen,
gone
man.
In this cafe.
Listen, man, they aren't going to get another turn before this is all over. All right. So.
Team Bound
this
and Broken.
Hail Mary.
Team Bound and Broken. Dax, you can steer, but Druk is paralyzed, so you can just steer. Unless
you know
you
what?
Do
we're right up against the wall.
Yeah, the other team is.
We'll skirt around the stink bomb situation. Because they're in the middle, right?
The way Quoin worded, the idea was you'd have to go through it if you wanted to proceed 30 feet.
Well, we're right up against the wall. We just go hug it and fucking go forward, my dude.
Full speed?
Full speed
okay,
ahead.
Then you end your turn in the fog cloud.
That's okay. I can see that there's a wall right beside us.
Okay, so,
I'm not disoriented. There's a very nice to the wall.
220. All right, so Team Quakey is 30 feet from the finish line. However, I need a d4 to see how the start of the round goes.
Yeah.
Oh, wait.
We just
last round. Happened. Could be the last round. You're near the end. D6 this time.
D6. Oh. Is there a blue turtle shell? Is there a blue turtle shell?
D6.
All right, so I rolled a 6.
Blue shell? Blue shell? Blue shell?
It somehow magically turns around, and the beginning becomes the end. The end becomes the beginning.
Oh, yeah, so.
No. Mobius cube. Mobius strip, rather.
There we go. Is it Morbin time?
It's Morbin time. No. A massive crab obscures the finish line. And a 15 will hit the basin, and it grabs onto Team Quickie's basin. I need the driver.
Things escalated.
I need the driver to make a strength saving throw to see if you can resist the crab throwing your thing back.
Ah! All right, let's go.
This crab does not disappear.
That 20.
Oh, nice. There it is.
Yeah, it should be contested, I think.
Oh my god.
Come on, giant crab.
It's a fucking giant crab.
Is it a giant blue crab?
Yeah.
Yeah, less is
it? It doesn't throw you, but you're still in its claws. You're just being held, grappled by the crab. All right, Team Quickie, what are you doing as your action? It's contested to break out of the grapple. So you're still not moving.
Wait.
The driver has to use their action to break out of the grapple.
Wait, okay, quick, wait. Question. What is it that... Does the tub need to pass the finish line for us to win? Okay, so it's the tub, not us.
With you in the tub.
Right, yes. Mr. Quoin, what do we do?
The driver has to make an action to break out of the grapple.
I know, I'm trying to see if I've got anything else.
We go forward.
So the rest of you just see this massive crab appear and just go...
Alright, I guess I'll roll. Is it a strength save, you said?
It's contested. It's a grapple check, right? So it'd be
to
break out of a grapple.
Oh,
to break out of a grapple.
Oh, that'd be acrobatics.
And it's contested. So the crab got a 29.
Good. I can't beat that. Crap. Okay.
Oh, crab.
Oh, wait. No, I actually could. I could with a nat 20.
Okay, go for it.
I'd have to get another nat 20.
Okay, go for it.
Got this.
I didn't. I got a 16 total.
Okay, so you're still grappled, and the crab's still, like, grappling onto your base, and it's going...
You got this, don't worry.
How strong is this giant crab that I got
very
a 29?
Strong. It's gargantuan.
Ah!
Quoin.
Bonus action. I'm going to throw the smoke bomb.
It's an action to throw a smoke bomb.
Oh, then my action.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Okay. At the crab?
No.
Oh, okay. I was going to say.
Throwing it. I mean, he's not going to let go. He doesn't see it. Throwing it behind us, so it should hit the 240, but I'm throwing it so that it... Oh, well, I guess it just would explode anywhere. 20 just feet high.
Carpet bombing the backline.
240.
Okay, so the 240 points, another fog cloud. Okay. So, Team Bound and Broken will have to go through another fog cloud. Cool. That's going to bring us to Team Dead Air.
All right.
There's just a crab at the end.
There sure is. However, but I am still a giant owl.
Here's the weird thing.
Don't. Please. We're still in last place. Give me hope.
Coming out of the crab are like these smaller crabs that are spinning on the surface of the water. Just.
What?
Are they green or are they red?
They're green and red.
Oh, no.
It's a mixture. Kenna. Roll a d4 to determine what kind of these crabs comes jettisoning towards your basin.
What if I'm still an owl and I just pick up the basin?
No.
And...
Roll this first.
Okay. What kind of check?
D4.
D4? Okay.
One for green, two for red. One, two for green. Okay. So one of these green crabs comes flying towards your basin because it's not a red crab. It's not homing directly towards it.
Uh-huh.
So it has to make an attack roll. Red ones automatically hit.
Yeah. Love how we're playing Mario Kart now.
Yeah. A 10 does not hit the basin, so the green crab just goes.
Yes!
And it will start to go. Oh, there's someone else behind you, so it just.
Nope.
So what are you doing?
A reminder.
I'm gonna grab hold of the basin's mast again, and fly action and movement. Right. 120.
Flitz, you're no longer paralyzed, by the way.
And I fly 120 feet.
You can't dash.
I can't dash.
I'm gonna rule for this. You can't dash because it's certain. Your team's starting to get real cheap. A little unfair.
And all right.
And you're carrying something too.
Yeah.
That's all right. That's fair.
Half movement speed for carrying something.
We're gonna say it's half movement. Half whatever your flying speed is, have it.
Uh-huh. All right. So I'll take my 60, just my measly 60 feet of movement.
What's the giant animal's total fly speed?
60.
So it'd be half because you're carrying something, so it's 30.
Oh, it's halved and can't dash?
Oh.
Yeah, I gotta make it. While shipping to a giant island,
we're they're in last place.
Okay, fine. Fine, 60 feet. You get 60 feet.
That is fair.
Flitz doesn't weigh anything. So you get 60 feet ahead.
I'm actually technically still hovering against the mast because I'm just literally like I'm just grabbing on like a mast to sail, like wee.
I love that you guys.
All right, so you guys are at.
I love that.
240.
I honestly don't mind losing.
240. All right. Flitz, are you doing anything? You're not paralyzed anymore.
Can we see anyone?
Vibing.
At the end of the movement, at you would be 30 feet behind the winning team.
Come on.
I'm just imagining Flitz, you can see
the other team
Jack Sparrow
in the claws of this crab. And then as you get closer, you can see this crab has enough claws for each basin.
Oh, no.
It also, if they're at 240, 30 feet behind us, they gonna be in a fog cloud.
Yeah, your movement will also end you in a fog cloud.
Okay.
So you can't see anybody, but when you're flying, you could.
Okay. So as we pick up and we land in the fog cloud, right as we get to the end, he's gonna take a shot, but he's gonna try to shoot the crab.
You're gonna try to restrain the crab?
Ooh, sure. Nice. Yeah.
Fuck this crab.
It's a net design for grappling a humanoid.
Well, like, could we grapple the long claw that's determined for us?
He's gonna make it look like he's shooting, but he wants to try to make two of the claws like one of the free-handing claws, and then like the one of the claws that is grappling theirs.
Each claw, it looks like it has designated for each basin. So like one claw says Team Quickie, one claw says Team Bound and Broken, one claw. The claws that are grappling Team Quickie
Does it look like Team Quickie's gonna get hit by one of those random shells?
It depends, it's for anybody to get to see if he gets hit.
Can I hold my action to try to shoot a crab that looks like it's gonna try to hit the Team Quickie?
Yeah.
So if it looks like one of them's directing to he's gonna try to stop it.
Are you holding your action then?
Yep.
Team Bound and Broken. You are in a fog cloud.
Oh, you're right up against the wall, and I knew I was going.
You're in
right,
a fog
like,
cloud, so roll a d4 because you ended in a fog cloud.
3.
Yeah. So the opposite direction. Into another wall. So you don't really go any, you don't move forward.
How far are we from the finish?
80 feet.
Truck, go forward.
I'm trying.
I can do it.
20 feet ahead is Team Dead Air.
Okay.
That's
just saying.
Cool. I want to move 30 feet, not 20.
Yeah.
I can't. If I shot at them, I could only go 20 feet forward.
Yeah.
I'm going to try hitting the wall again.
All right, make an attack roll. You are in a fog cloud with a disadvantage.
I thought we just got out of it.
I believe Quoin peppered the back area of this region.
Yeah, everything behind them is like.
Yeah, everything behind them is just fog. So.
Quoin just went to a fucking town.
I've made it a nightmare.
Yeah. All right, let's see how this goes. Oh boy. 13 doesn't hit.
No, not the wall.
All
And this is disadvantage. Hey. Disadvantage.
Yeah, 20.
20 hits the wall.
Whee!
Brrr, so 30 feet ahead. All right. So that'll put you at 250. So you pass Team Dead Air, and you're 20 feet behind Team Quickie. Team Quickie! One of you roll a d4 to see what shell comes flying at you first.
Ah!
Or crab.
Coin, you got it.
Do it, Ricky!
All right.
1, 2, green, 3, 4, red.
One!
One, it's a green one. So, Flitz, you held your action to shoot at... make an attack roll.
I tried. 11.
So you missed that crab. And the green crab has to make an attack roll on the grappled...
Oh, no.
...vessel.
What's that even going to do? Knock us free?
Nope. It does not hit your basin. And it just bounces off the wall, ricochets, and goes backwards towards the team that would be directly behind, which is Team... Bound and Broken. So it's going to fly towards Bound and Broken's vessel.
Ah!
God.
So it hits Bound and Broken's vessel with a 14. I need the steerer to make a strength saving throw of Bound and Broken.
Strength saving throw? Okay.
Oh, no, wait.
Just so clear, the name was Bound and Unbroken. Oh. But, whatever. Yeah.
I thought it was Bound, not Broken.
I thought it was Bound and Broken, and I was like, okay, that's a swipe.
Yeah. Never mind, no swing save. It just knocks, when the green one's hit, it knocks your basin back 10 feet.
Oh, no.
You with 21, goddamn.
Yeah, you get knocked back 10 feet.
And then I wish we had got hit by that.
So, and then it continues on, because that's what the green shells do. And then I need Team Dead Air. Oh, I need to see if it hits Team Dead Air. So, 14 plus 1, 15. So, poof, hits Team Dead Air, and Team Dead Air's yours also gets pushed back 10 feet.
No!
No! Oh, they don't even get a strength save, huh?
Team Rocket's blasting off again!
No, it's just push you back 10 feet. I ignored back the strength save because I ruled the wrong thing. All right, so Team Quickie. Try to bring over the grapple.
Actually, I do have a different idea for this.
Okay.
So, Ricky's feeling desperate. Ricky is just panicking. We're so close to winning. He wants to look cool for his heroes, but he's panicking. So he just leans over and he's just like slapping the claw, off the side of the basin.
Mm-hmm.
I would like to try and hit it for a stunning strike.
Okay, make an attack.
Ah, nice.
This is your action.
Yeah. That is a 24 with the face mask bonus. All right, so DC 17 con save.
2 plus 10.
12. It is stunned.
So it drops your basin.
Coin throws another fog bomb 20 feet behind.
So that's going to hit 20 feet behind. It's going to hit 250. Okay, it doesn't hit anybody, but...
Aren't they 20 feet behind?
No, nope, green shells, the green crabs knocked both teams back 10 feet, so they're not.
Mm-hmm.
We got knocked back into the black cloud of...
So they got knocked back into cloud.
Yeah.
Both teams got knocked back into cloud.
I'll still throw it 250, so it's right in front.
Okay, so there's another patch of it directly in front.
Just a nasty
amount.
Team
Dead Air. Team Dead Air. I need a D4, please. For shell and for direction. So the first D4 for what shell gets thrown in your direction.
Flitz, you want to roll a D4 for shell and your direction?
Gotcha. 4.
So it's a red shell. That's an auto hit. So you get knocked back 10 feet. And then,
but in which direction?
You get knocked backwards 10 feet.
Aww.
And then, Kenna, D4 for steering. Because you're still in the fog cloud.
That's a 2.
So you go directly into the wall.
But can I... Could I fly up.
Oh, you know what? I fucked up and I said ruled earlier because when Sam asked this, I said you can't use your own movement to move things.
Aww.
I did rule that earlier when Sam asked a question about movement, and I should have done that for your wild shaping, but I didn't.
I asked if
realistically I did rule it that you have to stay in the basin and move the, and the basin has to be moved by the basin's movement speed. So realistically,
regardless, I like where we're at. It's cool.
Yeah. You'd be pushed back 10 feet. The team dead air would be at 220. So you have 60 feet.
He's just gonna try to throw the at the stun thing.
So you do your 60 feet. Do you do your 60 feet fly speed?
Yeah.
Oh. You'd fly right into the wall, so you'd be.
I feel like that knocks me out of my wild. Like a bird going into a window.
Okay, yeah, full speed into a wall. You're no longer an owl. Flitz, what are you doing?
As we're coasting over the top of the, or we're coasting right when we clear it, he's gonna have just the whole gun, and he's just gonna throw it as hard as he can at the big crab.
You're gonna throw the gun at the crab?
Yeah, fuck it.
The whole gun.
That's so American.
You're 80 feet away from the crab. I don't think you can throw this 80 feet.
Shit, he's gonna try to touch you with. Okay, not really how far away he is. He's just gonna throw it.
Just roll d20 on your dex modifier.
Okay. fuck off. Dirty 20?
Dirty 20. You know what? That hits the crab.
Yes! So it takes...
Which is currently...
Whatever...
It takes one damage. One damage.
Plus four thunder
whatever your,
damage.
What's your, what's your unarmed strike damage?
Zero.
So, no, wanna kill so no damage. Just
it takes four damage because I have my elemental gift and if I hit somebody with an attack roll, technically they take four damage.
It would have been with advantage because it was stunned, but it hits anyway.
It's fine. I still, yeah.
Okay.
About
team B&B. D4 for shell, D4 for direction.
I mean, I just gotta say, Dax is being the least violent person this episode.
D4 for shell, D4 for direction.
I was like, I was saying, that crab is someone's pet.
Is three for shell? Because shell is first.
Yeah, three for shell.
So that's a red shell auto hit, so you get moved 10 feet back.
Alright.
So, and then D4 for direction.
For direction... Tis a two.
Okay, so you don't really move anywhere.
It just boinks us into the wall.
You're 10 feet behind Team Dead Air. Alright, Team Quickie. You have 30 feet to the finish line. The crab is stunned.
Take pity.
Let's go!
Alright, you pass the finish line. All of the effects end and the other basins can casually glide to the end of the finish line.
I'm just sitting in the basin, dizzy from headbutting the wall.
And Mercutio's like, well, that took a long time. The VIP event that you've all been promised is right now. And that's where we're going to end the session for the week.
Hey!
That's
a VIP.
Congratulations, team cheaters.
Play an entire, we are the only ones playing by the rules here.
Excuse you?
We were playing by
team
the rules.
Dead Air were the
team Dead Air was the cheaters. 100%.
Yeah. Easy. Easy.
It was good.
Chaos.
Whole race except
we're the
one
chaos.
Round.
Yeah.
Easy, but, team Alanis. You're all just a bunch of jagged little pills.
But,
isn't it ironic?
I made that up in 10 minutes, and you can tell.
Yeah.
That's where we're gonna end the session for the week. We'll be back next week with the VIP bathhouse experience. So, and then.